this afternoon for the Rangers of Northwestern Oklahoma. Clarkson, straight drop, now forced out of the pocket. In trouble, sack! There it finally is. We've been waiting on that sack, and it is big Rovell Carter.
Well, how he's been getting away from a lot of them. That time, Rovell Carter doesn't get his arms on him. He just kind of wraps him up and lays down on top of him. You're not getting away that time.
The first half, Hayden Mallory scales behind him. Mallory's going to pass, got time, going to the end zone. Intercepted! It goes back to Washington. Coming up with it, Hayden Laster, the senior out of Warren.
Laster with the interception in the end zone, and he played that one perfectly.
Hayden Lassiter, the senior out of Warren, is his holder. Here we go. Snap, hold, kick, trying to get there. It is good! It's good! It's good!
Oh, don't you love this celebration on the Washington side? Everybody with their hands in the air saying it is good. Gabe Goodman from Arkadelphia nailed it.
There's Edwards back in there. He may go! 45-50, 45-40, 35-30, 25-20, 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land, touchdown. He just went all the way. He went 72 yards. Second down, 10 yards needed for a first down. Now Connor Flanagan goes in motion right to left. Out of the shotgun, called quarterback keeper, running room, 30, 25, 20. They are not going to catch Grant Allen. He's to the land of milk and honey. There are no flags down. Touchdown, Grant Allen. Touchdown, Washington.
Zaylin Falls, Justin Dean deep for Washington. After 21 months away, Washington football is back. Falls at the 6, cuts over to the 10, the 15, the 20, the 25, the 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 45, 40. Hits the far sideline to the 30. He's to the 20. He's to the 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land. No flags down. Touchdown, Washington.
Kendall Gibbons right up the middle. First down, Washington. He's going, he's going, he's still going, he's going to the promised land. It's Kendall Gibbons, it's a touchdown, Washington. Other side, that's the wide side of the field protect this time. He looks this way, can't find anybody. Sack! Back at the 29-yard line, it was Damian McDonald. Going to be the direct snap to T.J. Cole. Isaac Edwards set to his left. Cole. Looking up the middle of the field, finds running room as he cuts back right. He's going to be to the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land. No flags down. Touchdown, T.J. Cole. Touchdown, Washington.
Well, he just got around that edge, Rex. And once he got to that edge, you knew he was going.
Tigers trailing 21-0. But with a 2nd and 7 now, with their deepest penetration so far at the 33. T.J. Cole, good running room, gets away at the 20, the 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land, touchdown, T.J. Cole. The Tigers are finally on the board. He set on the near hash mark. They are going to pass. Looking, Morse has time. It's batted in the air, and it's intercepted. It is intercepted by Washington, coming up with it on the first possession, Terrell Gibson. Touchdown, Washington!
Play up at the buzzer. Is it going to be an inside the Parker? Yes, it is.
I'm Nicole Auerbach from The Athletic.
Hey, this is Alex Pruitt with Sports Illustrated Magazine.
This is Kevin Kugler of Westwood One.
Hi, everybody. It's Pete Kranica of the Memphis Grizzlies and Fox Sports Southeast.
This is Danielle Musselman.
This is Kyle Peterson with ESPN.
This is Tom Hart of ESPN and the SEC Network. Thanks for tuning in to the Washita Sports Digital Network.
Tailgaters converging on Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia, Arkansas, as football is finally back on the campus of Ouachita Baptist University, and Tiger Nation is fired up. Good evening and welcome to the Captain Henderson House pregame show. I'm Chase Hartzell, joined by Chris Gay, and Chris, it's good to be back.
Man, I'm so excited for Tiger football to be back at Cliff Harris Stadium. It's going to be a great game.
Well, I can tell you there are a lot of fans in the house tonight that are just as excited as you are. Football has been has had a great few years here at Ouachita. Already coming into this game, number 8 in the country on the season. And not to mention that, we've got a Tiger Tunes reveal coming up at halftime for the theme. I mean, you can't ask for much more than that here on this first night of Tiger football in Cliff Harris Stadium.
Yeah, great day for Ouachita and great day to be a Tiger. Let's be sure about that.
Well, Chris, let's go ahead and talk about this matchup that's coming up. The number 8 Tigers, fresh off a win last week, 38-14 in the season opener against Southwestern Oklahoma State. Now coming back to face another school from the Sooner State, the Northwestern Oklahoma State Rangers, who are looking to get some redemption after a loss to UAM in their season opener.
Yeah, for those that didn't tune into that Southwestern game, that was obviously a great passing attack for Ouachita, not known for having a strong passing attack, but I think that's something we're going to see a little bit different this year. Riley Harms, 4 passing touchdowns and almost 300 yards in the air. But something I want to see from Ouachita this game, we have to establish the run. Kendall Givens, under 50 yards last week, phenomenal running back, one of the best running backs in the conference. He's got to get it more involved, really.
Well, and we'll talk about more of the keys to success when we bring up the Fish City Grill recipe for success later in the broadcast. But folks, we have a great show for you tonight. Not only the recipe for success, but we'll also have an interview with John Merriman prior to the announcement of all the Tiger Tunes themes, again, Tiger Tunes on homecoming weekend. So we'll hear from him. But before that, we're going to actually go from week 2 back to week 1 and take a look around the conference. This is the GAC Week Rewind from last Thursday night.
This is the Week 1 GAC Rewind. I'm Chase Hartzell. Ouachita retained the Paul Sharp Cup with a 38-14 win at Southwestern Oklahoma State. Quarterback Riley Harms threw for 283 yards and 4 touchdowns. Connor Flanagan led the Tigers in receiving with 5 receptions for 126 yards, averaging just over 25 yards per catch. Kimontre McKnight caught 4 passes for 54 yards and 2 touchdowns. This 11-yard pass from Harms to McKnight with 3 seconds left in the second quarter gave the Tigers a 28-0 halftime lead. Here's Rex Nelson on the Ouachita Football Network.
On second and goal, low snap, he picks it up, throws it into the end zone, caught! Touchdown, Ouachita, and the Tigers have put points on the board again as Kimontre McKnight brings it in with only 3 seconds left in the first half.
UAM used 22 straight second-half points to pull away from Northwestern Oklahoma State, 49-24 on the road. Boll Weevil quarterback DeMylon Brown threw for 388 yards and 4 touchdowns to sink the Rangers' chance of a win on opening night. Wide receiver Nick Howard finished the game with 140 receiving yards and 3 touchdown receptions, including this 52-yard scoring strike early in the second quarter.
So here we are, 12:30 left to go in the first half. 17-14. Weevil's on top. Brown under pressure. Throws complete breakaway speed across the 40. Downhill to the 30. And here goes Arkansas Monticello all the way to the end zone trying to see if we can get a number on that guy. And I think you're right. That is Nick Howard who just took one to the house.
SAU pulled away from Southeastern Oklahoma State in the fourth quarter on their way to a 34-19 win at home. The Mule Riders scored 10 points in the fourth after only being up 1 going into halftime. Quarterback O.B. Jones threw for 117 yards and rushed for 94 more, while accounting for 4 touchdowns in all. Dawson Scott recorded 3.5 tackles for loss for the Mule Rider defense.
Jones's fourth touchdown of the game came midway through the fourth quarter, providing the final score of the game. Here's that call from Dan Gregory on the Mule Rider Sports Network.
Scales to the right of Jones. Now they'll look off to the sideline. Line up once again. Here comes the snap. Jones keeps. Jones runs it straight ahead. He gets a good play.
Yeah, they push him across. Touchdown, Southern Arkansas. More insurance points for the Mule Riders with 6:58 to play. A 2-yard run for O.B. Jones.
Harding dominated the first half on its way to a 53-20 victory over Southern Nazarene in Bethany. The Bisons led 35-0 at the half, and the defense kept the Crimson Storm at bay all night as they forced three fumbles and had three interceptions. Harding running back Blake De La Cruz had four touchdowns on 11 carries. Harding quarterback Cole Keelon found Braden Jay in the end zone to give the Bisons a 28-0 lead in the second quarter. Here's the call from Billy Morgan on the Harding Sports Network.
Bootleg to the left, and now looking to throw, and Keelon throws downfield. Touchdown, Harding! Caught in the end zone by Braden Jay. 26-yard strike on the bootleg, and the Bisons now lead it 27-0 with 8:21 remaining in the first half.
Henderson State scored 21 second quarter points and 31 unanswered in a 41-13 win over East Central in Arkadelphia. East Central had the lead throughout most of the first half, but a 4-yard touchdown pass by Andrew Edwards in the second quarter began the ready run. Edwards finished the game going 17 for 25 passing with 276 yards and 4 touchdowns. Chris Hatzis caught 2 of those touchdowns, his longest being this 54-yard touchdown reception in the third quarter. Here's the call from Blake Smith with the Henderson State Sports Network.
2:42 and counting left in the third quarter, 27-13 readies. It's been that way for a little while. New tight end Cameron Gallagher comes in motion to the right side. Screen pass complete to Hatzis. Gets the outside. He's got some room, and Chris Hatzis turns on the Jets. No one's going to stop him. 10-5. Touchdown readies.
Oklahoma Baptist held Arkansas Tech scoreless through the first half and prevented a late rally in the Bison's 23-21 win in Shawnee. Tech fell short during a late fourth quarter comeback due to the Bison's defense led by Brett Carhu, who had 7 tackles, 3.5 tackles for loss, and 2.5 sacks. The Oklahoma Baptist offense had 329 yards of total offense, with 130 on the ground and 199 in the air from quarterback Aiden Thompson. The first touchdown of the season for the Bison came from Aaron Smith on this 3-yard run, as called by Todd Miller on the Bison Sports Network.
Sharp is in the backfield. Marshall split wide left to the near side is White Bear. They'll hand it off to Smith, running right. He'll walk the dog into the end zone. Touchdown, Oklahoma Baptist.
This week in the Great American Conference, there will be one game on Thursday night, a 6 o'clock kickoff between Southern Arkansas and East Central. On Saturday, 4 games will kick off at 6 o'clock, including Henderson State at Southeastern Oklahoma State, Southern Nazarene at Arkansas Tech, Southwestern Oklahoma State at Arkansas Monticello, and Northwestern Oklahoma State at Ouachita. The lone 7 o'clock kickoff on the night will be between Oklahoma Baptist and Harding. This has been the Week 1 GAC Rewind. I'm Chase Hartzell.
Captain Henderson House. We're a home to call your very own when you're away from yours. With a porch to end your night on, surrounded by friends, sharing stories and old times. And a yard with memories of summertime weddings and picnics after the game. We are so thankful for the life this house has seen for nearly 150 years. Come stay with us and join in on our stories. Captain Henderson House, Inn and Events.
At Taylor King Law, we understand that being injured can be a stressful and overwhelming experience.
And that's why we're here to help you every step of the way.
As your dedicated legal team, we'll stand by your side when you're being ignored.
We'll be on your side to fight for the compensation you deserve.
Don't let the insurance companies intimidate you. Let us go to work for you.
Call us today and let us help you get back on the road to recovery.
On your side, by your side. When you've been injured, we're here for you.
Yeah. Yeah. Five. Right.
And welcome back to the Captain Henderson House pregame show. Right now we have a special guest, the Director of Alumni Relations for Ouachita, as well as the Ouachita Student Foundation, John Merriman. John, welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks. Glad to be here.
Well, right now, getting ready for the home opener, but also another big tradition tonight, the reveal of the Tunes themes for Tiger Tunes. So, for some of our fans that haven't gotten to go to the event yet, one they definitely should in the future, and maybe some of our fans from the opposing fan base, you know, what is Tiger Tunes, and what does that event entail?
So, Tiger Tunes is an all-campus sing production. A lot of schools have them, and they're all about 50 years old or so, 50 or 60 years old. We learned how to do ours from a sister Baptist school, and we've been doing it for 45 years. And it's grown from one show in Mitchell Hall to now five sold-out shows in JPAC. It raises over $200,000 for student scholarships. So what people will expect to see is all of our social clubs will do a six-minute show based on a theme. It can be anything from gnomes to crayons, all kinds of different things like that. And they rewrite all the lyrics to be about that theme.
Well, you have an interesting perspective because you not only got to experience this from the faculty side, you've also gotten to experience it from the student side as an alum of Ouachita. What was your first Tunes experience like?
Yeah, so I came to Tunes as a prospective student, and that's really what sold me on Ouachita. I got a free ticket when I came to visit. The curtain opened and I was done. I was going to Ouachita. That was what made the decision for me. And then as a student, I was in the Ouachita Student Foundation. I was actually the student director of the show, which Joey Wisenhunt is directing this year. I was able to do that. My wife, who I met at Ouachita, she was the president of OSF. So OSF is a really important thing to us. We're really glad to be back and to be working with the show.
You mentioned OSF. It's a busy time for the foundation right now. What all work is going into preparing this event, not only for the students, but for all the guests that are coming in for homecoming weekend?
Yeah, so tickets went on sale and sold out in just a couple of days. So that's been really exciting. We're preparing for the live stream of the show, which people can buy tickets at obu.edu/tunes and watch wherever they are. We are gearing up for a silent auction and doing all kinds of things to get ready for the show. Probably the most important thing to the students is practice starts in JPAC on Monday night. That's the first time you start putting the show together on the stage where people will see it.
Well, an important step in the process tonight with revealing the Tunes theme. Yes. Before all the themes are revealed tonight, are there any from years past that really stick out to you as some creative themes that haven't been really common?
I personally really love an inanimate object tune show, like traffic barrels or rocks or matches. Things that don't talk are kind of my faves, just because you have to be really creative to make something talk that doesn't talk. So I love a tune show like that. But there have been really great ones in the past, and you'll see some really fun ones tonight as well as we reveal the themes at halftime.
And really quick, John, before you go, what would be your elevator pitch to someone who hasn't been to Tiger Tunes as to why they should come to this event on the weekend of homecoming?
Well, it's just a really fun way to raise money for scholarships. So we think there's no more fun way than to watch students perform and to also be able to give that money back to their peers to stay and finish their education. So if you've never been, just get online, try to find tickets from a friend, watch the live stream, try to be able to get there and see it. It's part of the overall homecoming and family weekend, which will also be great. And that schedule is at obu.edu/homecoming.
All right. Well, thank you, John, for joining us again. Tiger Tunes coming up homecoming week. So be sure to make a stop at JPAC for the show. Good luck to you, John, as well as to OSF in putting on the event. And good luck to all the clubs that will be competing in the show.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
All right. We'll be back with more of the Captain Henderson House pregame show after this timeout.
I'm Rex Horn, the Interim Executive Director of the Arkansas Baptist State Convention, and today I'm joined by my friend Dylan, who's an attorney with the Arkansas Baptist Foundation, with an important word for you.
The foundation is here to help you support your Ouachita Tigers. If you'd like to create an estate plan that supports Ouachita and its mission, or learn about other giving opportunities, please contact us using the information below.
Bats and signs all around Arkadelphia. When you see the Badger equipment trailer on the way to a Badger game, Bats and Signs did that. When you're watching the Badgers, Tigers, or Reddies and see the signage that just really makes their facilities pop, Bats and Signs did that too. You see the signage in downtown Arkadelphia, on the campuses of Ouachita and Henderson, or the sign in your neighbor's yard supporting a candidate or their favorite Badger? Yep, Bats and Signs did that too. Longtime residents and supporters of all things Arkadelphia, called Mark, Jared, Chris, or Ryan at Bats and Signs today to see what they can do for you.
I've heard people say, oh, a cheetah.
Oh, Wichita.
Oh, a cheetah.
Is it pronounced oh, a cheetah?
Searching for Ouachita Baptist University.
Back in Texas, everybody pronounces it Wichita, but really, it's Ouachita.
Ouachita.
How would you pronounce it?
Ouachita.
It's Ouachita Baptist University. Get it right.
It's Ouachita, people. It's Ouachita.
Ouachita.
Make Printmania in downtown Arkadelphia your place to get embroidery, screen printing, trophies, and more. Drop by their store on Main Street in downtown Arkadelphia or visit their website at printmaniatees.com to see how they can help your business or group. Need a shirt for an event? Let Printmania take care of that. Need promotional materials for your business or organization? You can let Printmania take care of that too. A family-run local business in Arkadelphia, Printmania has been serving the public since 1992. Call Printmania today, 870-246-3803.
Visit the Ouachita Campus Store for all your Tiger apparel, merchandise, and gifts. If you need something to wear to show your Tiger pride, stop by the Ouachita Campus Store on the bottom floor of the Evans Student Center to grab a t-shirt, sweatshirt, polo, or more. If you can't stop by the store on campus, visit us online at bookstore.obu.edu. Make your purchase and we'll send it to you. Support the Tigers by checking out the Ouachita Campus Store. Go Tigers!
Baseball for me just kind of was the glue that kept my family together, I feel like. I was able to come here and get my triple major as well as play a super high level of baseball against some of the best players in the country. There's a lot of options here in Division II with a lot of great ball players and a lot of great people, and they make sure that they give you every opportunity to succeed on and off the field.
Captain Henderson House. We're a home to call your very own when you're away from yours, with a porch to end your night on, surrounded by friends, sharing stories and old times, and a yard with memories of summertime weddings and picnics after the game. We are so thankful for the life this house has seen for nearly 150 years. Come stay with us and join in on our stories. Captain Henderson House, Inn and Events.
And welcome back to the Captain Henderson House pregame show. This is Chase Hartzell joined by Chris Gay. And Chris, just a few moments ago, we talked with John Merriman about OSF and the upcoming Tiger Tunes event during homecoming weekend. A lot of events going on around Ouachita's campus, starting with athletics. A lot of teams in action. We had a couple of women's soccer broadcasts, both victories for the Tigers, but also a lot of other teams in action this week as well.
Yeah, you know, on top of football, we have volleyball that's going to be starting. I guess the first conference game is this week. I think it'll be this Tuesday against Henderson State. Like you said, both men's and women's soccer. Soccer will have their first home game pretty soon. And then, like I said, volleyball, but cross country has also been competing. And they've had some success so far. There's also been tennis. Tennis has just started their season, and swim and dive is going to start their season here pretty soon.
Well, with athletic events and just events in general at Ouachita, it always seems like there's something to do, whether you're a student, a community member, anybody's welcome. There's a lot of good things coming up right now, and especially this week with the school year really starting to go into full gear. And we're going to take a look at OBU. This is This Week at Ouachita.
Hello and welcome to This Week at Ouachita. I'm Haley Short.
And I'm Kay Ellis.
And we are your hosts every week. But speaking of big weeks, this is a huge week for Ouachita. This could be nicknamed the anniversary week.
That's a good name.
For Ouachita. Mm-hmm. So September 4th was Ouachita's 100th anniversary for Cone Bottoms. And all of you alumni probably have taken pictures on the steps of Cone Bottoms. It's a huge part of just Ouachita as a whole. And so they had a huge celebration. They had lawn games. They had purple ice cream. They had lemonade. And on Cone Bottoms lawn, they had an aerialist. She was in silks doing lots of little tricks and everything.
So cool.
It was 1920s themed, so they threw everything back, and it was kind of a time travel trip backwards. But mm-hmm. One of the things that I could have never called from Ouachita doing was bringing a hot air balloon onto Ouachita's campus.
It was so cool. So many students got to go up into
massive.
It. Massive. And the line was so long.
I mean, neither one of us made it in the line, and we're the host of the show. I mean, we should get VIP passes.
Absolutely. But, I mean, it was a huge hit.
I mean, the line was so long for it. I think they're going to bring it back. They've teased it, so this is my announcement. Watch how you should bring the hot air balloon back to the students.
Please do. Fingers crossed.
No, yeah. But we also had an even larger anniversary this week. Tell us about that.
Yes. Well, on Wednesday, September 6th, it was 137 years of Ouachita. And Ouachita commemorated by doing this sweet Instagram post with some really old photos, and it was really cool to see what classrooms and people looked like back then. It was incredible. The communications and marketing team has done an outstanding job this semester on social media platforms. It has been so fun to watch.
And if you're an alumni, this is basically us telling you, you may be able to see yourself on Ouachita social media in 137 years, so, but Instagram probably will be long gone by then.
Probably.
Hopefully something new to kind of bring into the mix.
Yes.
But speaking of students
at
Ouachita.
Speaking of Tigers young and old, we had a Tiger Day on Monday the 4th where tons of prospective new students got to come. It was hosted by OSF, so there were tours and just lots of information for future Tigers, and it was really fun to see all the tour groups going around campus and learning all about this school. It was so fun to see.
They always host a lot of those throughout the year. I always get caught off guard. I'll walk outside just doing my own thing and I feel like a zoo animal. You just turn and there's a group of people just staring at you.
Yes, just
trying
to
live your life. And it always scares you. But speaking of like that many new students we have, this again was one of the largest freshman classes we've had at Ouachita.
Yes.
But we actually, this is the first year in Ouachita history that they've had to do a chapel overflow. So, like, JPAC is packed to the brim that they had to put everyone in overflow in Berry Chapel. We're actually both in there this semester.
Yes.
So it looks a little different. So it's just kind of more a stripped down acoustic version of worship. Acoustic piano, maybe a little cajon, drum. But that's basically the worship you'll have. And again, it's probably a little over 100 students in there.
Probably about 100, 150 students. And yes, the acoustic worship led by Blair Yeager. And then they live stream the speaker. So you're basically getting the same experience that those in JPAC are. But we just have so many enrolled right now that we had to have an overflow for the first time in Ouachita history.
It's very interesting. If you get out early, your other friends are still in chapel. You're kind of like, I get to go to the food court first. So it's a weird adjustment, though, because chapel was always the thing for Ouachita, that was the thing that everyone came together. So seeing it be separate is very interesting, but it kind of creates a more intimate environment, I feel like.
Oh, I loved it. The worship was incredible in the smaller Berry Chapel.
And Berry Chapel is a part of Ouachita history as well. It just creates that environment of worship, and it brings the students closer together, I feel like, because you're sitting in a pew. You're not in a seat. You're not in like an auditorium seat. So I think it's a different vibe for chapel, but I'm very enjoying it a lot. But we also, on Friday the 8th, actually yesterday, we had the host and hostesses of Tiger Tunes. We performed at Stew Fridays at Coffee House. And so it was a good, fun little set. They always do this every year. It's kind of like a little preview for the people that are going to be singing. But I was able to perform, and all my friends came out and supported me. It was really fun. We got to sing a little bit of Harry Styles, Taylor Swift, but it was a good group. And that's always the thing that's interesting about Coffee House, is you never know who's going to perform. And if you don't know a lot about Coffee House, it's just every Friday, people call it Stew Fridays, at around like 12:15, 12 o'clock, you'll have some students that can sign up and just go in there to perform, or like just do a song or whatever they feel like doing. Typically, it's like 2 to 3 songs.
Mm-hmm. I think so, yeah.
But it allows students to showcase their talents on campus. And it's not just performing arts majors. You'll have lots of different people that will want to come and perform. And it kind of cultivates an environment of growth for the students.
It does.
I feel like.
And this one specifically got campus so excited for Tunes. We are ready for it.
Yes. Well, speaking of Tunes, you guys need to get back to your Tiger football game. Well, thank you for watching this week at Ouachita. I'm Haley Short.
And I'm Kay Ellis.
Captain Henderson House. We're a home to call your very own when you're away from yours, with a porch to end your night on, surrounded by friends sharing stories and old times, and a yard with memories of summertime weddings and picnics after the game. We are so thankful for the life this house has seen for nearly 150 years. Come stay with us and join in on our stories. Captain Henderson House, Inn and Events.
At Taylor King Law, we understand that being injured can be a stressful and overwhelming experience.
And that's why we're here to help you every step of the way.
As your dedicated legal team, we'll stand by your side when you're being ignored.
We'll be on your side to fight for the compensation you deserve.
Don't let the insurance companies intimidate you. Let us go to work for you.
Call us today and let us help you get back on the road to recovery.
On your side, by your side. When you've been injured, we're here for you.
And welcome back to the Captain Henderson House pregame show. Chris, do you smell it?
Something smells pretty good, honestly.
Yeah, it smells like they're cooking up something pretty good over there on that Wachita sideline. Oh, what's this? Would you look at that? It's a gift from our friend Brett Brundage, class of 1997, Wachita grad, and the owner of Fish City Grill in Rogers.
Well, how about that?
I know there are a lot of Tigers up there in Northwest Arkansas, and he sent us a little gift here. Our fans should definitely go visit him, but it's the first ever Fish City Grill recipe for success.
Yeah, it is. And first thing I got to mention, and I mentioned it earlier, Wachita threw for just under 300 yards last game, four passing touchdowns. They have to replicate that success, but they got to get that run game going. That's what they're known for. That's their trademark. They got to get it going.
And you have to feel like for Northwestern Oklahoma State, a big part of that recipe for success is going to be limiting the run game and forcing the Tigers to pass. But the thing is, you've got to be prepared for anything because the Tigers have proven in the past that they can hurt you both ways, through the air and through on the ground.
Yeah, definitely. But something that I think they have to look out for Northwestern State, they struggled in their opener last game against Monticello. DeMillon Brown, he just threw all over them, so their pass defense is a little, you know, it's struggling. This is going to be a game for them to really try to get back on track, but you also got to think about they have to get that running attack going. It was pretty solid last week. They got to replicate that same success.
For Northwestern Oklahoma State, over 200 rushing yards as a team last week. Passing game, couldn't get it going fully yet, just over 100 yards passing, but you have to think if they can get that air attack going and get a balanced attack, it's going to be a tougher test for the Tigers.
Yeah, definitely, and I think the defense is going to be big in this one, too. They have a very solid linebacker core, and I'm going to be very interested to see what, like, Antoine Martin is able to do. He had a very strong game, almost 10 tackles, tackle for loss in the previous game. So it's going to be interesting what the Rangers are going to throw at the Tigers.
So it sounds like the Rangers are going to have a tough test on defense, but the Tigers are going to have a tough test with that running attack as well. So I think the run on both sides of the ball, zoning in on that on defense, is going to be a recipe for success here tonight.
Yeah, definitely. And another thing I'll add is, of course, in Wachita's season opener, they were great passing, great in the air. Connor Flanagan, over 100 receiving yards. Keymontre McKnight, 2 receiving touchdowns. They're going to be huge in this game. Both starting receivers for the Tigers are going to be really interested in what they're able to do here tonight.
And running back one for Wachita this year is Kendall Givens. Givens has had a lot of success at Cliff Harris Stadium. Some people may not realize this, but in his freshman season back in 2021, he actually tied the record for most touchdowns in a single season by a Tiger here at Cliff Harris Stadium. So this is a place that he loves to play. He learned under TJ Cole. They create a great dynamic. Now he slides up into that running back one role. It'll be interesting to see how he develops in that role and continues to build on that leadership presence.
Well, a lot of that has to do with what the offensive line is able to do. The offensive line, their pass protection was great last week, only 2 sacks allowed, but they couldn't really get holes opened up for Givens, for Edwards, for Henley Jr. It'll be really interesting to see if they're able to kind of – it's a young offensive line. It's going to be interesting to see if they're able to get back on track coming into week 2.
Getting good experience for the offensive line, getting the run game established, continuing the dominance of the air. Sounds like a great recipe for success for the Tigers here tonight.
Yes.
All right, well, we are getting closer to kickoff, and we will have more coverage of Tiger football coming up after this timeout. Thank you again to Brett Brundage of Fish City Grill and Rogers for sponsoring this segment, and we'll be back with more Tiger football after this.
I've heard people say, Owachita.
Owachita.
Achita.
Owachita.
Is it pronounced Owachita?
Searching for Washita Baptist University.
Back in Texas, everybody pronounces it Wichita, but really, it's Washita.
Washita. Washita.
How would you pronounce it?
Washita.
Washita.
It's Washita Baptist University. Get it right.
It's Washita, people. It's Washita.
Washita.
Bats and signs all around Arkadelphia. When you see the Badger equipment trailer on the way to a Badger game, Bats and Signs did that. When you're watching the Badgers, Tigers, or Reddies and see the signage that just really makes their facilities pop, Bats and Signs did that too. You see the signage in downtown Arkadelphia on the campuses of Washita and Henderson, or the sign in your neighbor's yard supporting a candidate or their favorite Badger? Yep, Bats and Signs did that too. Longtime residents and supporters of all things Arkadelphia, called Mark, Jared, Chris, or Ryan at Bats and Signs today to see what they can do for you.
Captain Henderson House. We're a home to call your very own when you're away from yours, with a porch to end your night on, surrounded by friends sharing stories and old times, and a yard with memories of summertime weddings and picnics after the game. We are so thankful for the life this house has seen for nearly 150 years. Come stay with us and join in on our stories. Captain Henderson House, Inn and Events.
Visit the Washita Campus Store for all your Tiger apparel, merchandise, and gifts. If you need something to wear to show your Tiger pride, stop by the Washita Campus Store on the bottom floor of the Evans Student Center to grab a t-shirt, sweatshirt, polo, or more. If you can't stop by the store on campus, visit us online at bookstore.obu.edu. Make your purchase and we'll send it to you. Support the Tigers by checking out the Washita Campus Store. Go Tigers!
Make Print Mania in downtown Arkadelphia your place to get embroidery, screen printing, trophies, and more. Drop by their store on Main Street in downtown Arkadelphia or visit their website at printmaniatees.com to see how they can help your business or group. Need a shirt for an event? Let Print Mania take care of that. Need promotional materials for your business or organization? You can let Print Mania take care of that too. A family-run local business in Arkadelphia, Print Mania has been serving the public since 1992. Call Print Mania today, 870-246-3803.
Owned by OBU alumni, Java Primo is the official coffee house of Washita Tiger football. At Java Primo, amazing coffee is just the beginning. Try our great options at breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and don't forget about our amazing desserts. Also, shop Java Primo's gift selection 24/7 online at javaprimo.com.
I'm Todd Knight, head football coach of the Washita Tigers. When you're in Arkadelphia, come down to Main Street and support Java Primo, the biggest Washita Tiger fans in town.
Go Tigers!
Go Tigers!
I'm Kendall Givens, and thank you for tuning in to the Washita Sports Digital Network.
I'm Nicole Auerbach from The Athletic.
Hey, this is Alex Pruitt with Sports Illustrated Magazine.
This is Kevin Kugler of Westwood One.
Hi, everybody. It's Pete Kranick of the Memphis Grizzlies and Fox Sports Southeast.
This is Danielle Musselman.
This is Kyle Peterson with ESPN.
This is Tom Hart of ESPN and the SEC Network. Thanks for tuning in to the Washita Sports Digital Network.
Riley Harms, Fremont, Nebraska.
Kendall Givens, Little Rock, Arkansas.
Connor Flanagan, Fayetteville, Arkansas.
Bo Baker, Bells, Texas.
Key McKnight, Warren, Arkansas.
Garrison Jackson, Gentry, Arkansas.
Zach Henson, Alma, Arkansas.
Jarvis Gulley, Sherwood, Arkansas.
Galen Williams, Tithkin, Arkansas.
Nate Turner, Conway, Arkansas.
Dylan Horton, Laurel, Arkansas.
Mike Gonzalez, Tampa, Florida.
Chancellor Taylor, Fort Worth, Texas.
Chop Burks, Wilson, Louisiana.
Braylon Buller, Pine Bluff, Arkansas.
Dawson Miller, Heath, Texas.
Jax Miller, Heathville, Louisiana.
Trey Proctor, Enfield, Texas.
Mario Ganter, El Dorado, Arkansas.
Steven Weston, Palm Bluff, Arkansas.
Josiah Johnson, Little Rock, Arkansas.
Dante Gibson, Junction City, Arkansas.
Gabe Goodman, Arkadelphia, Arkansas.
Joe Couch, Torquay, Australia.
Carter McElhaney, Greenbrier, Arkansas.
Isaac Greer, Greenwood, Missouri.
In life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiating.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Game in a positive manner. Profanity, racial comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Also, consumption or possession of alcoholic beverages is prohibited in Clipperas Stadium. The Great American Conference and Ouachita Baptist University thank you for your cooperation.
To 196 yards. It was the best defensive performance in the GAC in week one. Speaking of Kamontre McKnight, it was a welcome return to the lineup. He had a productive outing in that first game after missing the entire 2022 season with an injury. He is a junior from Warren, and he scored Ouachita's first touchdown of the season with a 19-yard receiving touchdown in the first quarter. He added another receiving touchdown with 3 seconds remaining in the first half to put the Tigers up 28-0 at the break. He went on to have 4 catches for 54 yards. So good to see Kamontre McKnight back in the lineup, young man from Warren, Arkansas. Connor Flanagan was Riley Harms' favorite target in the game. He had 5 catches for 126 yards, accounting for Flanagan's third career 100-yard game. Well, we're just getting close now to the kickoff of the home opener. What a huge crowd has turned out for this game. We're very excited to bring it to you. And that concludes the Baptist Health Tiger Countdown to Kickoff. Football is coming your way next here on the Ouachita Football Network, presented by Visit Hot Springs.
Thank you. Tiger Nation, Everett Auto Group is proud to support difference makers like Ouachita Tiger Cross Country and Track and Field. Discover the Everett Difference at theeverettdifference.com. Captains for this afternoon's coin toss are for Northwestern Oklahoma State, number 0, Isaiah Curry, number 3, Isaiah Kellum, number 4, Antoine Martin, and number 14, Mason Myers. Captains for the Ouachita Tigers are number 21, Kenton Jones, number 42, Mikey Gonzalez, number 76, Zach Henson, and number 84, Joe Couch.
More students enrolled at Ouachita, so it's a very exciting fall semester. Very exciting to have the first home football game here. This is Jeff Root. Along with me is Richard Atkinson. Richard, it's a great setting for football. The sun's a little warm for us here in the box, but it's a very nice day compared to a couple of weeks ago. This is as close as we've seen to football weather on an afternoon.
Yeah, it is. Once that sun dips down, it's going to be perfect. Only about 84 degrees, but you're right, that sun's warming it, but not a cloud in the sky. A fantastic day for football and a huge home crowd. Sometimes you wonder on that first day when it's kind of warm if the crowd's going to show up. They certainly have today.
Good luck, gentlemen. Ouachita has won the toss and deferred to the second half, so it looks like Ouachita will play defense first, and that defense is a strong one. A good performance last week, Richard.
Yeah, and coming into this year, we talked about it. We talked about it last week. The offense had lost a lot of production, especially on that offensive line. Of course, lost T.J. Cole.
And now.
So the defense might help carry him.
Tiger Nation, let me hear you!
The offense was a little slow going, and the defense played great. And the offense caught up. It's something we haven't seen in the last 7 years out of these Tigers.
Oh, yeah, you got it right. Richard had raised his voice a little over the crowd because the crowd responded to TA announcer Dr. Casey Modell as he announced that the Tigers were entering the field. On the far side, we see Northwestern Oklahoma State University entering the field. This is a team that is struggling to come forward with a freshman quarterback, but they have high hopes today here in Arkadelphia.
Yeah, they do. And, you know, they hung tough with UAM last week and eventually ended up losing that one and dropped it 49-24, but they put up some points. And this is a team that Ouachita's really not had a ton of trouble with through the years. They've been able to beat them. But you can't think about that coming in. You've got to always be ready. It's a new coach, so you never know what you're going to get. And some young players. And some young players, they like what they lack in experience, sometimes they can make up for in athletic ability. This is a Todd Knight team, though, that never really overlooks an opponent, comes in very well prepared every week.
Captains today for Ouachita include Kenton Jones. He's from Marion, Arkansas. This young man has finished his undergraduate degree and is now a graduate student at Ouachita. Also, captains today include Mikey Gonzalez, a defensive lineman from Tampa, Florida, Zachary Henson, an outstanding left tackle from Alma, Arkansas, and Joe Couch, who is an outstanding punter. We think maybe an All-American before it's all done. All-American, interesting, because he is from Australia, but he is an outstanding student and a great young man. Love to talk to Joe. We'll probably do him for a pregame interview at some point. He has a lot to say, and we love to hear his accent. Right now, we'll see how much he'll have to punt today, but first we'll see if the defense can force a punt on the first possession by Northwestern Oklahoma State University. So for the play-by-play, let's go to the voice of the Tigers, Rex Nelson.
Thank you, Dr. Jeff Rood. Dax Jaggers will kick off for the Tigers, and the home opener is underway on a sunny afternoon as Jaggers' kick will go out of the end zone, and it'll be first and 10 from the 25 for Northwestern. Richard, we saw a very good defensive performance a week ago. Washington's defense only allowing 7 points in the game, and that's when the subs were in.
And they got, and that was off a bad snap, is what it was. The defense didn't allow any points. So,
well, actually, the defense allowed seven.
And they had 5 sacks last week too, Rex. I think that's the big thing. Some of that's from pressure from linebackers, but they did a good job generating pressure up front. Mikey Gonzalez and Chance Taylor, defensive ends, both of them did a good job getting upfield and getting to the quarterback. So this is one of the better defenses we think we'll see from Washington in a while.
Caleb Deal is the quarterback for Northwestern Oklahoma, as Northwestern will start 1st and 10 from its 25-yard line. Going left to right in this first quarter of play. First play from scrimmage of the home opener. Empty backfield. Deal is going to keep it himself. Coming left in trouble and only gets a yard. Good pursuit that time by the Washington defense, Jeff, as they were all over Deal out there. Leading the way for Washington was Jax Miller.
Really good play by Miller. Interesting formation. They sent everybody to the right side, then ran the quarterback to the left, but he just had nowhere to go. Picked up just a yard, so watched on a good first down, looking for a big play on second.
Deal on 2nd and 9. He'll hand off over left tackle. Not much there up to the 29-yard line on the running play. And, Richard, it probably brings up a passing situation now. It'll be 3rd and 6 from the 29.
Yeah, and this is a team last week in the Rangers that had 295 yards of offense. 183 of that on the ground, only 112 through the air. So they do like to run the football, but you're right. I think this is going to be a passing down here for the freshman, Caleb Deal.
2 wideouts to either side for Deal on 3rd down and 6. Deal, straight drop back, pressure on, in trouble, sack, back at the 18-yard line, and it'll be 3 and out for the Rangers.
Here's Josiah Johnson, the safety blitz that time. It was a slow-developing play. It wasn't a quick blitz, and he had plenty of time to get back there, and quarterback never had a chance once Johnson got on him, and that's a 3 and out, another sack in the column for the Tigers.
And should be very good field position, you would think, after this punt. We'll see what kind of return Connor Flanagan will get. Now, he is looking into a bright sun, by the way. This field, remember, goes east and west, so he is looking west into that setting sun, and that could cause a problem. Very high snap. Washington does not have the rush on, and it's a short kick. Wow, you couldn't ask for any better than that, Jeff. Washington is going to start its first offensive possession in Ranger territory at the 47.
Gavin Green is a receiver and the punter. That came off the side of his foot a little bit and did not take a Ranger bounce, so it didn't make the 50-yard line. The offense onto the field. A lot of passing last week. They want to run the ball well. Also, we'll see some of that today. What will they choose to do on first down? First possession of the game for Washington.
They'll come out of the pistol. Riley Harms, the quarterback. Kendall Gibbons, the running back, set to his right. He's going to pass on first down. Got a receiver out in the flats at the 40, 35, 30. Breaks a tackle inside the 25 down to the 21-yard line. Connor Flanagan.
Yeah, and that route was actually jumped by a Ranger, but it was just a perfectly thrown ball. Got it right over the defender. Big pickup from Connor Flanagan there on the roll.
Tigers going no huddle out into the flats. Got a receiver again already in the red zone to the 15, down to the 14-yard line, where it'll be 2nd and 4, Jeff.
Well, passing game and a quick-paced offense. Now they're going to slow down just a bit, bring a fullback in, a wide receiver out. They might go to a little bit more of a running game, but the passing game has worked beautifully so far.
Boy, just like that, Washington already down to the 14-yard line. Kendall Gibbons set to the left of his quarterback, Riley Harms. Let's see if they go to the ground here. Here they do. Big hole. 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised land. Touchdown, Kendall Gibbons. Touchdown, Washington.
A little bit bigger of a hole than he was seeing last week, Rex. That time he got it. Big hole over right guard and was able to just cut it outside and easily get in for 6. And Kendall Gibbons is a touchdown machine, gets his first one here today, and the Tigers are showing out for this big crowd. 3 and out on defense with a sack, and then 3 plays and a touchdown.
Boy, what a start. We're not even 3 minutes deep. 12:09 still left in the first quarter. Gabe Goodman to attempt the extra point. Snap, hold, kick. Good. Our score, Washington 7, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Washington football 2023, presented by Visit on Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
I've heard people say Ouachita.
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 Is it pronounced Ouachita?
Searching for Ouachita Baptist University.
Back in Texas, everybody pronounces it Wichita, but really, it's Ouachita.
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 How would you pronounce it?
Ouachita.
Ouachita.
It's Ouachita Baptist University. Get it right.
It's Ouachita, people. It's Ouachita.
Ouachita.
Captain Henderson House. We're a home to call your very own when you're away from yours. With a porch to end your night on, surrounded by friends, sharing stories and old times. And a yard with memories of summertime weddings and picnics after the game. We are so thankful for the life this house has seen for nearly 150 years. Come stay with us and join in on our stories. Captain Henderson House, Inn and Events.
Run was not working as well, and they score on the long run from Kendall Givens there as he's able to scamper into the end zone. So, yeah, this is looked great to start off. You know, you see around college football sometimes, Rex, teams sometimes come out a little flat when they're expected to win. We did not see that at all from the Tigers so far today, and that's good to see, especially in front of your home crowd.
Dax Jaggers will kick off for the second time already, and we're not even 3 minutes deep into the football game. Big home crowd, as Jeff mentioned, for the home opener. Jaggers kick again into and out of the back of the end zone. So first and 10 again from the 25, and we'll see if this defense can put pressure once again on quarterback Caleb Deal. He is a freshman out of Frisco, Texas, so they want to put a lot of pressure on him, and certainly did with that sack. Is they did not pick up the blitz at all, Jeff, on their first possession.
They did not, and the safety got there. Johnson made a nice hit on the freshman quarterback. I also give credit to Jaggers. I mean, we're talking about two kicks that landed 8 yards deep in the end zone with no help from the wind.
Yeah. Boy, we're downfield, downwind now from the hamburgers grilling. They smell good, don't they? And I see the smoke now floating across the field. On the ground, give left, only 1 yard. And it's second and 9, and Rangers finding the going tough here early, Richard.
Yeah, I know it's Trey Proctor on the tackle, played safety last year. They moved him down to linebacker now and did a great job holding his block, holding the man off of the block and making a one-arm tackle there. And the Rangers want to run the football. That's what they had success with last week, but they're going to be hard-pressed to beat these Tigers running the ball.
Yeah, they really are. They're going to have some success through the air to stay in this one. They are passing out on the left flat. This time, do have a receiver. Tackle made short of the first down, but it's going to bring up third and short. That was a gain out to the 20, well, out to the 34-yard line. And so it's going to be third and a long yard here, Richard, and you would expect a running play, of course.
Yeah, but they're in the shotgun. Not really a power formation here. They don't have a tight end or anybody in.
Yeah, but they're going to give it on the ground, and it's easily going to be a first down. Out over the 40, out to the 42-yard line goes Darian Gill. He is a junior out of San Antonio, Texas, and the Rangers, Jeff, have their first down of the evening.
Really good run. Gill did have a good week last week, over 100 yards rushing, 6 yards a carry. He's their best offensive weapon so far.
First down and 10, ball at the 42-yard line. Three running backs this time for the Rangers. Give on the ground again, and nothing this time coming left as the handoff goes to Brandon Reichert, and they were waiting on him that time, Richard.
Yeah, Matthew Burton, the defensive lineman, was all over him. They had three men lined up at the quarterback in the backfield, but there was no confusion there from Burton. He immediately recognized the ball carrier, made the tackle. They're going to give him about 6 inches or so, it looks like.
We'll call it second and 10 from the 42. Ouachita leading 7-0 early in the first quarter. One running back this time to the right of the quarterback Deal. So look for him to pass. He will straight drop back in trouble. Flushes him out. Got some running room. Over the 45, out of bounds, out at the 49-yard line. Did a good job, Jeff, turning it into a 7-yard gain, and it'll bring up third and 3.
Opportunity to cross the 50-yard line for the first time. The entire game has been played on the Rangers' side of the 50 so far. They need this third down to keep the offense on the field, give their defense a chance to get ready for that Wichita offense again. Wichita's going to set up to defend what could be a pass or a run from this distance.
Got trips left, one man right. Darian Gill is the running back. Let's see if they keep it on the ground on third and a short three. Deal? No, he's going to pass. Again, in trouble. Sack! Back at the 33-yard line.
Dawson Miller that time. And
oh, the ball came out. The ball came out, and it belongs to Wichita.
It was Bruin Barnes, excuse me, not Miller, but Bruin Barnes that time on the blitz, that time from the outside. They brought pressure on the same side twice so far and have both ended up in sacks. And I like what Washington's bringing. They're bringing the pressure, not allowing the quarterback to get comfortable on third down.
I never saw the ball come out, but luckily the Tiger defense did, Jeff.
And he was hit, and the ball came loose just before he hit the ground, and then the Tigers quickly fell on it.
From the 32-yard line, another short field on the ground. Kendall Gibbons, good running room again. Forced out of bounds on the far sideline. That is the Northwestern sideline at the 25. It'll be second down and three.
Yeah, I didn't see that ball come out there either. Thought it was just a great sack, but it worked out even better. And this is a great time for the Tigers to take a 14-0 lead. Just 9 minutes, 9.5 minutes still to go here in the first quarter.
Already down to the 25-yard line now. They come out of the shotgun this time on second and three. Given set to the left of his quarterback. Going to pass out into the left flats. Got a receiver. Breaks a tackle. Connor Flanagan to the 20, to the 15. Walking the sideline down to the 13-yard line. That'll be a first down, Wichita in the red zone.
The defender played everything well. He just didn't make the tackle. Flanagan, not a huge human being, but really a fine, fine football player. Just hard to hit square. They couldn't knock him down immediately. Made two good moves and got a first down.
First down and 10, Wichita. They are at the 13-yard line, already leading by a score of 7-0. Kendall Gibbons to the right of his quarterback. They pitch to Flanagan, though. Lots of green. 2-1. Promised land. Touchdown, Wichita.
And that's feed the hot hand there. Flanagan looked good on the last one. They pitch it to him, and he's got speed to the outside. Was never touched. And the Tiger offense and defense, Rex, both look really good right now.
All cylinders firing in this first quarter on a warm night in Arkadelphia. 13-0 Wichita already with 8:48 left in the first quarter. Gabe Goodman to attempt the extra point. Snap, hold, kick. Good. Wichita 14, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Wichita football 2023, presented by Pissett Hunt Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
I'm Rex Horn, the interim executive director of the Arkansas Baptist State Convention, and today I'm joined by my friend Dylan, who's an attorney with the Arkansas Baptist Foundation, with an important word for you.
The foundation is here to help you support your Wichita Tigers. If you'd like to create an estate plan that supports Wichita and its mission or learn about other giving opportunities, please contact us using the information below.
I'm Rex.
At Taylor King Law, we understand that being injured can be a stressful and overwhelming experience.
And that's why we're here to help you every step of the way.
As your dedicated legal team, we'll stand by your side when you're being ignored.
We'll be on your side to fight for the compensation you deserve.
Don't let the insurance companies intimidate you. Let us go to work for you.
Call us today and let us help you get back on the road to recovery.
On your side, by your side. When you've been injured, we're here for you.
Say between week one and week two, you make your best improvement. Coach Knight sometimes says between two and three. But they obviously got some things figured out. But it also helps Rex. The defense has put them in fantastic positions on both these opening drives.
Absolutely. Everything clicking early for Wichita, and the big home crowd is loving it. Boy, this is quite a crowd, Jeff.
It's really a great crowd. Good to see. Good weather. Going to be even better when the sun goes down, but still good weather. Everybody enjoying the action so far. Crowd really into it.
Dax Jaggers kicks off for the third time tonight. This one will be returned from the goal line. Coming left, he should have downed it because he's down all the way back at the 11-yard line.
Yeah, I think his return team just kind of thought it was going in the end zone, didn't worry about blocking because when he caught it, it was about four or five black shirts in front of him and no blockers. You're right. He should have just taken the touchback there.
Yeah, Wichita wearing the black shirts with the purple numeral, the Cincinnati Bengals-style helmets again, white pants tonight. First and 10. He's just a freshman. Caleb Deal has to be a little shaken by now, I would think, Jeff.
Well, they've come for him twice, and they got him both times. And the second time, he let go of the ball a little bit too soon. The officials called it a fumble. Wichita jumped on it immediately and touchdown, Tigers.
So we got Deal and Gill in the backfield. Deal gives to Gill. Gill comes left, and he loses yardage. Back to the 7-yard line. Therefore, washed up Dante Gibson.
Yeah, the safety coming up, making a big tackle. I don't think the Tigers are worried about the pass at all, and so they're just going to tee off on the run, and that one never had a chance. And that's what you want to do. When you got a freshman quarterback, you want a good run game to take the pressure off of them, but it's not working so far.
Second and 14 now as a passing situation will come up for Caleb Deal. Rangers trailing Wichita 14-0, moving left to right midway through the first quarter. Rolling left, looking for a receiver. Can't find anybody. In trouble. Finally lets it loose. Finds a man now out over the 20. Good job of scrambling and then throwing against the grain and finding Laith Shelley, his big tight end. Give him credit, Jeff. That's a hard throw to make against the grain when being chased down, and he completed it.
It was a dangerous throw, but he made it work. He got it to the tight end and then ran for yardage. Wichita all over the quarterback. Looked to be in good shape in the secondary, but a good play for Northwestern.
All right, first and 10 at the 23. Here's Gill. Gill being strung out, and he's going to be dropped for a loss of one. Or no, for a gain out to the 27, I'm sorry. And it'll bring up second down. Darian Gill on the carry.
Made a nice play or in the hole, kind of jump cut to the outside because it looked like a Tiger was going to be there stopping for no gain again. Did a good job of leaving him in his tracks and getting outside. And a little momentum from the Rangers. They're outside from the shadow of their own goalpost now.
Second and 6. They have it at their 27. Rangers come to the line of scrimmage. Set on the far hash mark, and now we've got a timeout on the field. So we will pause. 6:52 left in the first quarter. It's Wichita 14, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Wichita football 2023, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
Owned by OBU alumni, Java Primo is the official coffee house of Wichita Tiger football. At Java Primo, amazing coffee is just the beginning. Try our great options at breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and don't forget about our amazing desserts. Also, shop Java Primo's gift selection 24/7 online at javaprimo.com.
I'm Todd Knight, head football coach of the Wichita Tigers. When you're in Arkadelphia, come down to Main Street and support Java Primo, the biggest Wichita Tiger fans in town.
Go Tigers!
Northwestern got a first down on the second and 6. They decided to call a timeout. Interesting time for a timeout after getting a little bit of momentum, but they needed to talk on the sideline. They had that conversation, and we go back to action.
All right, they send all four receivers, or send four to the left side, send another one to the right side. So an empty backfield now for Deal. Deal looking left side, has a receiver in the flats. Tigers are there, though, and immediately make the tackle at the 27. That didn't work at all, Richard. No gain, and now it's 3rd and 6.
Yeah, and this is a passing situation. The last two third downs, they brought pressure off that left side of the offensive line and gotten home both times. Josiah Johnson one time, and then forcing the fumble was Bruin Barnes the next time. We'll see if Wichita brings pressure again from that same spot. Barnes is out there looking like he may be blitzing.
I bet they do. The freshman quarterback, Caleb Deal, comes out of the shotgun. Two receivers to either side now on 3rd down and 6. Snap, straight drop back. Now he's going to scramble, trying to run for the first down. He's going to be nowhere close. Boy, that play went nowhere quickly. Jeff, right back to the line of scrimmage, 4th and 6, so they'll have to punt the football away.
He ran back to the short side of the field, just ran out of real estate. They never hit him, but he had nowhere to go and finally gave up and ran out of bounds.
Well, to have called a timeout, I wasn't real impressed with the two plays coming out of the timeout, Richard.
Yeah, it didn't amount to much, and Wichita was ready for the quarterback run on that one. Jax Miller was just kind of in a spy, and when he took off, there was just nowhere to go.
Exactly. So let's see if Connor Flanagan can get a return. Again, looking into a bright sun, and he's just going to get out of the way. This one gets a little better bounce, but still going to be good field position out at the 37-yard line, Jeff.
Yeah, we had a couple of players get tangled up on the near side, but no harm, no foul. I don't see a flag, and we are back to work for the Ouachita offense. The first time a play will be run from the Ouachita side of the 50-yard line.
That's a good point. I had 37. I said pretty good field position, but the worst starting field position by far so far in the game.
It is, but they've been picking up yards in chunks. They might be across the 50 after this play. They've been hitting Connor Flanagan a lot. He split out here to the near side.
Yeah, he's had quite a start today. Send the tight end in motion. Quick snap. I think Ouachita is going to have the penalty here. Free play. Got a wide open receiver at the 30, at the 25, at the 15, at the 10, at the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Touchdown, Chris Hightower. And let's come back and check the flag.
Definitely going to be some offsides. I thought there was contact, so I thought they would have stopped the play, but they didn't. Called it a free play. Hightower kept going, and so did Harms, but the defenders did not. Hightower, when he got it, there was no doubt he was going to score. He's got speed.
Yep, offside defense, and it is a touchdown, Ouachita, on the long pass to Hightower. 63 yards that one goes, and here comes Gabe Goodman again. Snap, hold, kick.
Yeah, what do we got?
They blew the whistle before the kick.
They forgot to pick up their flag.
Oh, okay.
They did have to run 60 yards back to get it.
Little extra work for Gabe here. Kick would have been good, as his usually are. So one play drive that time, Jeff. That's easy to sum up.
Yeah, the officials get a nice hand from the home crowd for running fast enough to get the flags and get back to action pretty quickly.
He made it down there pretty quick.
Boy, Harms took advantage of that free play, though, didn't he, Richard?
Well, and really the defender covering Hightower just stopped.
They quit. Their whole defense quit.
Yeah, there was one safety back there that might have had a chance, but Hightower was able to outrun him. I mean, that's like a 7 on air right there.
Snap, hold, kick, good. We're still in the first quarter, 5:18 left. It's now Ouachita 21, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Ouachita Football 2023, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Make Print Mania in downtown Arkadelphia your place to get embroidery, screen printing, trophies, and more. Drop by their store on Main Street in downtown Arkadelphia or visit their website at printmaniatees.com to see how they can help your business or group. Need a shirt for an event? Let Print Mania take care of that. Need promotional materials for your business or organization? You can let Print Mania take care of that too. A family-run local business in Arkadelphia, Print Mania has been serving the public since 1992. Call Print Mania today, 870-246-3803.
63-yard pass from Harms to Hightower. Goodman with his third extra point, and the Tigers have a 3-touchdown lead. We're not finished with the first quarter yet.
No, still got time in the first quarter. Let's see if Ouachita can keep up the intensity here. And this big home crowd still bathed in the early September sun is certainly enjoying what they're seeing so far tonight. Dax Jaggers will kick off for the fourth time already in this first quarter. This one goes into the end zone. He's going to run it out from 3 yards deep. Tigers have pursuit and going to be stopped again. Short of the 20. Now they're going to put it right on the 20-yard line. You think he'd learn and down that football, Richard?
Yeah, he's got some good speed coming out, but there was just no blocking there and had a better return there, but still not good field position. And the Tigers have had good field position all day, helped out by their defense. The Rangers have had not had good field position.
I was going to say he could have had an extra 5 yards by simply taking a knee saving the effort.
They gave up 15 yards on the last one.
Yeah, first down and 10 from the 20-yard line. And here come the Rangers again, already trailing Ouachita by the score of 21-0. We'll see if they're going to try something new now. Still going with the freshman out of Frisco, Texas, Caleb Deal. Deal will come out of the shotgun. Empty backfield, four receivers, or trips now to one side, two receivers to the other side. And we've got whistles.
There was one on the play clock, so it wasn't a delay of game.
Yeah.
Must have been some illegal motion.
I think they'll back them up five. Illegal substitution, all right. Be first down and 15. 12 men on the field.
Yeah, it looked like Gill was in motion, but he ran out of bounds. He was the 12th man.
Yeah. First down and 15 from the 15 for Northwestern. And again, an empty backfield. Trips to one side, two men to the near side. Send a man in motion. Pitch to him, and he's thrown down. Back at the five-yard line.
Yeah, that time with a big loss on the tackle of Matthew Burton. I mean, he was in the backfield waiting for it. It's going to be second forever.
Yeah, back to the six. So it's going to be second and 24 from the six-yard line.
Not good for a running offense.
Yep, not at all. Second and 24 back at the six. Northwestern in trouble already, trailing Wichita 21 to nothing late in the first quarter. Passing situation for Deal. Wichita has had pressure on him all night. Now they're just going to give it on the ground. Running back coming left. Another loss of yardage. This time back to the five-yard line as the give was to Javon Foster.
Wichita took the ball.
Ball came out. Now let's see where it is. They're unpacking them. Waiting. They say it is back to Northwestern.
Trey Proctor with the tackle. And that's what they like about him at linebacker coming down from safety. He's got sideline to sideline speed. Ran him down, made a big tackle there, and there's a pile for the ball. But coming up with it was Jashawn Foster.
Now third and 25 from the five. Wow. Clock running, 3:49 left first quarter. Casey Modell's calculator just broke. He just said third and long instead of third and 25. Couldn't get the math they've got so far to go.
He's a history and professor, right?
Yeah. Not math, yeah. Third and 25, quarterback throwing right. Got a man out there, intercepted by Wichita at the 50-yard line, being brought back to the 45, back to the 40, back to the 35, back to the 25, cutting right to the 20, 15, 10, 5. Flags are down. But a huge interception going toward the end zone by Washington's Josiah Johnson. How about that defense?
Heck of a return for the touchdown. It's going to come back, but still great job by Johnson reading the quarterback, making that interception. And then, yeah, there's a block in the back as we look at the replay here. But great job by that defense once again.
Absolutely. Josiah Johnson heads up. And that is the second turnover of the night that this Wichita defense has come up with. And, Jeff, one of the few things Todd Knight could find to complain about in the opener, which was a 38-14 win, was the fact that the defense came up with no turnovers. They already have two here in the first quarter.
Well, that was a great return also, spoiled by the block in the back. But the penalty did come after the interception, no doubt
yes.
about that. Wichita will have the ball.
And there's probably – I think there's more than one block in the back. There's three flags. It's a few different spots out there.
And that's why they're talking yeah. about it for so long. But you're right, it will be the Wichita offense back on the field, already leading by a score of 21 to nothing on this warm night in Arkadelphia, and almost a capacity crowd here on the home side.
And Josiah Johnson with a sack and an interception so far. Not a
yeah.
bad night for him.
And yeah, he's off to quite a start, isn't he?
You say almost capacity. There's actually a decent amount of Wichita fans on the visitor side, too, in the shade. You can see some blue or some purple over there.
Yeah,
so,
yeah, they want to get over there and get a little shade. That's true. It is a heck of a crowd tonight for this home opener. So let's see where they finally are going to spot the football after a long discussion.
I think the first block in the back was shortly after the interception. There were two more downfield.
Yeah, multiple flags all by the return team, Wichita. We knew that. We just wanted to see where they're going to spot the football, Richard, when all is said and
well,
done.
Well, one of those blocking the backs was against the quarterback, and it was a defensive lineman. I think he just saw quarterback, I'm hitting him.
Yeah. That's how they're trained, isn't it, on defense?
They're calling a blindside block?
Yeah, I think they're going to put it in Ranger territory at the 48. They are.
So another short field, though, for the offense, Jeff.
And they have scored, whether it's been short or a little longer so far. Last time a 63-yard pass play on a one-play drive. This time they have the ball at the 48-yard line of Northwestern, and everything has gone Wichita's way offensively, defensively, and on special teams.
All right, Wichita will try to add now to a 21-0 lead. Riley Harms out of the shotgun. Kendall Givens set to his right as the running back. Tigers start 48 yards away from the promised land. And we got movement on that offensive line this time, Richard.
Yeah, it was offsides. This time the defensive lineman made sure if he was going to jump offsides, he was at least going to knock the offensive lineman over so they couldn't have a free play.
Yep, yep.
The hard count, I mean.
Yeah, he made sure to make contact. You're right.
I guess Harms is going with a hard count, but the last two plays in a row, he's got the defensive tackles to jump.
He has. First down and five at the 43 on first and five. Let's see if they just give it to Givens. Low snap, picks it up, gives it to Givens. Big hole, watch out! He's going to the house! 20, 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1! Promised land! Touchdown, Kendall Givens! Touchdown, Washington!
Well, Givens with two touchdowns so far today, and he wasn't touched on that one.
One play drive again, Jeff, because we had the penalty, right?
First two touchdowns, three play drives. The next two, one play drives.
So 2 3 play drives and 2 1 play drives and a 4-touchdown lead, and we're not to the end of the first quarter yet. Holy cow. Gabe Goodman's got the most work of anybody tonight. Snap, hold, kick, good. Our score with 3:06 still left in the first quarter. Wichita 28, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Wichita football 2023, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
Baseball for me just kind of was the glue that kept my family together, I feel like. I was able to come here and get my triple major, as well as play a super high level of baseball against some of the best players in the country. There's a lot of options here in Division II with a lot of great ball players and a lot of great people, and they make sure that they give you every opportunity to succeed on and off the field.
Passing, it's been the ground game. But with as good as the offense have been, the defense has just been just as good, if not better.
I agree. Tigers just clicking in all phases. Offense, defense, and the kicking game. Speaking of the kicking game, Dax Jaggers will kick off again. Taken a yard deep. He's going to try to return it again to the 10. Breaks one tackle. Not going to get far, though. Down at the 13-yard line. Again, by taking a knee, Richard, he could have had it at the 25. He's got it at the 13 this time.
Yeah, Mario Ganter Jr. ran him down. That's one thing about Wichita, if you notice, you look at the special teams. Yeah, they got some guys that don't play all the time, but they got a lot of starters out there, too, that really know how to play some football. Ganter gets a special teams tackle down at the 13-yard line. He's staying out there because he's a starting cornerback.
The thing about Todd Knight is he stresses the kicking game, Jeff, just as much as offense and defense.
He really does. He's got not just great kickers, but he's got players, as Richard said, that really focus on doing outstanding work on the special teams. It makes such a difference in field position.
All right, so Caleb Deal will bring them back. First and 10 from the 13. Let's see what the offense does for the Rangers. Deal in trouble. Forced out of the pocket. Rolling to his left. Looking. Gets rid of the football and throws it away on the near sideline, which is the Wichita sideline. One of the coaches catches it and gets a big cheer from the Wichita student section.
Yeah, the students are having a good time tonight, aren't they?
They really are. Yeah, student section like that one, Richard.
I can't tell, but that may have been Big Frank Espy, who was here when I was here, and he was a defensive tackle, so he's got some hands down there.
Good hands for a tackle. Second down and 10, ball at the 13. Northwestern with the football, moving left to right, trailing Wichita by the score of 28-0. Deal with one running back this time. Deal gives to that running back, and boom,
A black shirt there waiting for him. Another loss, Jeff. This a loss of three as the give was to Darian Gill back to the 10, and now it's 3rd and 13.
Jackson Carter on that tackle. And we have a professor named Jackson Carter. That was not him. They're not lining up the faculty right now.
Good to know.
That
although
young
they
man
may,
made a
before
nice
this
play.
One's over, you may be going in. Get ready. We're going to use everybody tonight. 3rd down and 13 from the 10-yard line. You would think Deal would be passing here. He's got an empty backfield. Tigers bringing pressure again. Trying to run a quarterback draw, and he's dropped back at the 2-yard line. Boy, you talk about everything, and I mean everything going Washita's way. That was Connor Sharp. He's a sophomore out of San Antonio, Texas.
Yeah, they were trying to run a quarterback draw, and there was just a four-man rush that time, but just nowhere to go, and he kind of just made sure he fell down before he got tackled for a safety. And we'd have to look at the stats, Rex, but Northwestern is going to be close to 0 yards in this first quarter.
Yeah, yeah.
They've had two bigger plays, I guess, but most of them have been negative yardage.
Freshman Gavin Green will punt it out of the back of his end zone as they spot it at the 3. Here is the snap. Washita's got the return on extremely short. Take it at the 37. Here comes Connor Flanagan inside the 25. And this time, Washita's offense is only going to start about 24 yards away, Richard.
Yeah, and the starters are still going to be out there. I think you're going to start seeing, as this game goes on, especially in the second half, more and more guys come in. I bet you'll see a lot of Eli Livingston. But
oh, in the second half, yeah.
Yeah, Washita's got a lot of weapons to choose from out there. Everything is working.
Yeah, they'll mark it at the 25, actually, but just 25 yards away from the promised land, already leading by a score of 28-0. Out of the pistol, Kendall Gibbons, big running room, lots of green again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bingo, jackpot, promised land, touchdown Washita.
Third one-play drive in a row, Rex. Two of those drives have been Kendall Gibbons. This is his third touchdown in the first quarter. That breaks, I think he's over 40 touchdowns for his career now.
Sure we're not playing the Texas College Steers again, Jeff?
You know, this is truly amazing. Northwestern
amazing.
is a Division II legitimate team that struggles, but they've never struggled quite like this,
Not like this. Yet another extra point attempt by Gabe Goodman. Yet another one's good. It is now 35-0 with a minute 05 left in the first quarter. Now, we're going to have to get Brian to go back in the record books and see when the last time Washita scored 35 or more in a first quarter. I can't remember, but that's the situation. Washita Football 2023, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Washita Football Network.
Quarter, Washita 35, Northwestern 0. That was Gibbons on his third touchdown of the day, 25-yard run, 105 left, and Washita in complete control. Only one play has been run on the Washita side of the 50-yard line in the game.
Wow. Gibbons now 40 touchdowns in his Washita career rushing. Taken this time, a shorter kick at the 8, and the coverage is just great again. Down at the 16-yard line. Boy, this kick coverage has been unbelievable too, Richard.
Oh, I mean, and it's great to see the Tigers getting just as fired up for a great coverage on a kick as they do a sack, as Malik Relaford, the sophomore from Donaldson and played at Malvern, was in on the tackle that time. And I mean, this is a team in Northwestern Oklahoma that put up 24 points last week. It's not like a team that came in that you were expecting to score 14 points or anything. I mean, they put up some points last week, and they lost, but they have negative yards so far in this first quarter.
Wow. A minute left in this first quarter, first and 10 from the 17. Caleb Deal, the freshman quarterback. Deal gives on the ground, looking for running room, coming left. He breaks a tackle over the 20, one of their better runs out to about the 24-yard line goes to Sean Foster. That's about their best offensive play of the night. One of their best, Jeff, out to the 25-yard line.
He did a nice job of breaking a tackle. Again, he ran for over 100 yards last week. He's a good running back. He hasn't had much blocking so far tonight, but he did a nice job that time of breaking a tackle to get positive yardage.
And that's Jax Miller, the excellent linebacker for Washington that's shaken up down there. He made the tackle. I think it's Jax Miller. Let's hope he's okay.
Absolutely, because that is one of the better players on this defense.
He may be the best linebacker in the conference. Yeah. One of the top two or three for
he's
sure.
Up.
But
he's up.
That's in the ace seems fine, see. But yeah. That's in this game. I mean, he did have a guy fall on top of him, may have just lost his breath.
Yeah.
In this game, you start wondering or worrying.
Yeah, he
you
may
don't
be through
injuries.
For the night. Yeah. 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 I mean, if he's even a little shaken up with this kind of lead, Jeff, you call it a night for
him. You're going to be playing a lot of backups anyway. Let him rest, probably, unless he just forces his way back in.
Second and two, ball at the 25-yard line. Likely to go back to the ground here. Nope, they're passing play, and a dropped pass should have been caught. It was right in the hands of the intended receiver, Travis Romar. But dropped, and now it'll be third down and two from the 25. So we'll see here in a short yardage situation, Richard, if the Tigers can force another three and out.
They've allowed one first down so far, and this is kind of that in-between. Is, you know, you would think this is run situation a lot of times, but they've had no success with the run game, really. So I think they'll have to be passing here.
Third and two from the 25. Washita leading 35-0 with 22 seconds still left in the first quarter. Out of the shotgun. They are going to give it on the ground. It's a loss of yardage. And they are going to have to punt the football away. How about Bruin Barnes that time?
Yeah, he was just – they called the blitz off the edge this time, the near side. And he got there right as the running back got the handoff and had a great tackle. And this defense is not letting up as we're going to go to the end of the quarter here.
Not at all. Fourth and five from the 22. All right, listen to this. End of one quarter of play. Washita Baptist University 35, Northwestern Oklahoma State University nothing. Washita football 2023 presented by Visit Hot Springs continues with second quarter play-by-play in 60 seconds here on the Washita Football Network.
This is Flo. When Flo isn't waiting tables at the Sunrise Grill, she's waiting on sunsets in beautiful Hot Springs, Arkansas. It's time for a road trip. Plan your next vacation at hotsprings.org. This is Stella. Stella likes retro style and old school country. Stella also likes holding alligators. Time for a road trip. Hot Springs, Arkansas.
You're right, Russ. Thank you.
Flanagan will get as Washington leads it by 35 points after one of the best quarters we can remember from a Washington football team. This one allowed to bounce, and Flanagan's just going to get out of the way, and the offense is going to have its longest field of the night back at the 25, but distance doesn't seem to matter so far, Richard.
No, we're looking at the first quarter stats. Northwestern has run 23 plays for 1 yard, and then Michael Westbrook pointed out the most eye-popping stat, Rex. Washington has 35 points with 2 minutes and 14 seconds time of possession.
Gee, 205 yards for Washington, 1 yard for Northwestern. So Washington has outgained them 205-1 in the first quarter of play. I've never seen anything quite like that. Here is the give on the counter play on first down and 10, and it'll be a four-yard gain for Chris Henley. And Henley's a redshirt freshman out of Glen Heights, Texas. And, Richard, he looked pretty good in the first game out at Weatherford, Oklahoma.
Yeah, he did, and we've heard good things about him. I think we'll see a lot of them today. Isaac Edwards also is now in there.
Yeah, we may have seen the end of Kendall Givens for the night on a warm night. Give him plenty of rest before the showdown with SAU next week. Tigers set on the near hash mark. Going to pass out into the flats. Caught at the 30. Breaks a tackle. Out to the 33-yard line. Gain of 4 on the play. And it'll be third down and 2. So probably another running situation here, Jeff, on third and 2 with some new skill people now in the game for Washita.
Key McKnight on that catch. The junior back from an injury. Had a big game last week.
Oh, he had a huge game. Kamontre McKnight out of Warren. Here is the snap. Harms coming left. Got a receiver again out at the 35. 40 going down this near sideline to the 45. Runs over a man and goes to midfield and more. Wow! That time it was Washita's Jeremiah Turner, junior out of Tyler, Texas, and he was just running over people, Richard.
Yeah, you could hear that. Yeah, that collision up there. And that got the crowd in the sidelines fired up. He got an extra 3 or 4 yards, and that's a 3-yard pass that turns into a big gainer.
They're going to mark it right at midfield. But, Jeff, that's a 17-yard gain.
He is such a delightful young man and really playing a big part in the offense this year.
Harms with one running back. He's going to pass again. Looking, can't find anybody open. Now he takes off. He's got some running room. He's at the 48. Now the hole closes up. After a 2-yard gain, second down and 8, but yet again, Richard, Washita is in Ranger territory, leading 35-0.
He was the leading rusher for the Tigers last week. He's not going to be this week, and really at this point, you don't want him to run the football, Rex. Let's just get this throw the ball away and don't get hit in this game.
Absolutely. At this point, I tend to agree with you. Two wide receivers to either side, this time for Washita. Chris Henley Jr. is the running back, set to the right of his quarterback. Harms throwing again. Got a receiver at the 42 at the 40-yard line. Thrown out of bounds on the near sideline. That's the Washita sideline. It's Chris Hightower out of Little Rock Christian, a transfer from UCA. Again, another player that was pretty impressive in that first game.
Yeah, and of course, he caught that touchdown earlier. And I guess you combine that with Kendall Givens. Little Rock Christian's accounted for 4 touchdowns today for the Tigers. But he's somebody that, when he gets out in the open field, can be electric. And it's going to be fun to see them continue to use him in the offense.
First down and 10. Ball at the 39-yard line. Now Eli Livingston, they heard you talking, Richard, comes in. Livingston on the quarterback draw, and it's positive yardage down to the 37-yard line, where it'll be second down and 8 from the 37. And we'll probably be seeing a lot of Livingston from now on, Jeff.
I think we will, and they really do like his ability. He can run the football. He can pass the football. He'll check out this time, and Harms is back in.
Yeah, they use him on running plays a lot, but I think he'll probably run the offense in the second half, Richard.
Yeah, I think he will, and they're gonna use him, I think, to run in some formations a lot this year, but sometimes he's going to pass out of that. You like that that added wrinkle.
Second down and 8, Washita from the 37 of Northwestern Oklahoma. Harms passing again. Got a receiver out in the left flats this time. Short yardage down to the 36, and it'll bring up 3rd and 7.
That's Key McKnight again out there. And just a good tackle that time of the Rangers. They were missing that tackle earlier in the game. They made the tackle that time, but still a positive gain. And this is the longest third down that the Tigers have been in so far today. I think this is only the first third down the Tigers have been in today.
Wow. Third down and 7 from the 36 of Northwestern. Washita leading 35-0 in the second quarter of play. Henley, the running back. Harms is going to be passing. Can't find anybody open. Now looking. Now he's got an open receiver. Caught at the 2. Into the promised land. Yet another touchdown for Washita. As Hank Hatfield out of Little Rock Catholic brings it in.
I mean, that was just wide open. That was a good job by Harms finding him down the field. That, I don't think, was his first check. And Tigers have scored on every possession so far.
Wow. Now they've got 41 on the board. And we're just early in the second quarter. Goodman's extra point is up, and it is good. Well, well, well. What a night at Cliff Harris Stadium. It is now Ouachita 42, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Ouachita football 2023 presented by Visit Hot Springs continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
I've heard people say Ouachita.
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 Is it pronounced Ouachita?
Searching for Ouachita Baptist University.
Back in Texas, everybody pronounces it Wichita, but really, it's Ouachita.
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 How would you pronounce it?
Ouachita.
Ouachita.
It's Ouachita Baptist University. Get it right.
It's Ouachita, people. It's Ouachita.
Ouachita.
Down 8 plays, 75 yards. Harms to Hatfield for a touchdown. Hatfield's first touchdown as a Tiger. 36-yard pass on third down and 7. Ouachita leads it 42-0.
Everything that could go right, Richard, has pretty much gone right for Ouachita so far in this first half.
Yeah, I mean, they've scored on every possession, and that's the first long drive they've actually had to do.
Yeah, and they still end up with 7 points. 42-0 with 10:40 still left, Jeff, in this first half.
It has just been the perfect storm if you're Northwestern. The Ouachita defense playing at its top form, the offense playing at its top form, the special teams playing at their top form, and they're doing it in front of a huge crowd that's enjoying every minute of it.
You think Dax Jagger's leg is sore yet from kicking off? And Washington's going to get the football to start the third quarter, too.
Well, that's a long time from now, Rex.
Yeah, that's true.
10 minutes left in this quarter.
Score another 30 points between now and then, Richard. Here is the kick. This one going to be fair caught. Finally, he got the message, Richard.
Yeah, tried to break one a couple times and realized that was not going to work, and they're going to take it at the 25-yard line and
first and
see
10
if they can't
from
grind
the,
out some yards here.
First at the 25-yard line. Rangers will be moving right to left into the sun. Remember, this field goes east and west. They're moving away from the Ouachita River toward Carpenter Haygood Stadium, so that is westbound and down. First down and 10 from the 25.
Rex, a lot of the younger guys in now. It's going to be interesting to see as they get some experience in the first half of the game.
Yep. Caleb Dill still working at quarterback. The freshman looking to pass, across the middle, got a receiver. He's brought down at the 30-yard line after a gain of 5, second down and 5.
Yeah, he got rid of that right before he got
yep,
walloped by
that
Jack
was his
Miller.
Secondary receiver. Just get rid of the football, but it does result in a 5-yard gain.
They got some young guys in there, but they have a few of the starters in. Jack Miller's fine. He's back in there as he was shaking up earlier, and he
That's
almost had the sack
see.
There.
Another short pass, and it's dropped. That one was low, attempting to make a diving catch that time was Gavin Green, and he couldn't. So now it brings up 3rd and 5. Jeff, we'll see if Ouachita can force another 3 and out.
And if they do, Gavin Green, who was unable to pull that pass in, will line up as the punter. He's got double duty tonight.
Now they've got Ethan Everson at quarterback. Not 12, but 2, it looks like. Yep.
He's a senior.
So senior Ethan Everson, straight drop back, looking for somebody. Got a receiver this time out at the 30-yard line. Tackle made immediately out there, though, by Ouachita's Jax Miller, speaking of.
And that's Jax Miller running step for step with their 5'11", 165-pound slot receiver. That's impressive from a linebacker.
Another 3 and out, Jeff. This defense just not letting up at all.
Well, let's see. Is it going to be Flanagan back again? I think so. They I just love to watch him return punts, and he had a beautiful punt return last time to set up, or 2 punts ago to set up a touchdown. We'll see what he does this time.
And he's looking away from the sun this time, so he should pull it in even better. High kick. It's going to be fair caught, which he does at the 32-yard line. So that's where this offense will come back on. First and 10 at the 32. Wichita with the football, and you hear this correctly, a 42-0 lead with 9:33 still remaining in the first half.
And it looks like the second team offensive line, Eli Livingston's going out there. They're sending some backups in quickly, but we're going to have a stoppage of play here.
Yep, we're going to call a lot of names tonight, gentlemen. Get ready. Get your extra roster out and everybody on it. We're going to call a lot of names from here on out with a 42-0 lead. But great to see. Next week it'll get a lot harder. Southern Arkansas comes here, Jeff, and the Mule Riders, 20 of their 22 starters return this year, and they're off to a 2-0 start.
It's a very, very good team. Big comeback for the win on Thursday night. I'll tell you what, it's one of the reasons that Wichita has a successful team. They win enough games by enough points. The young guys get to play. They get some experience before they're counted on as a starter.
Absolutely. Absolutely, and that's the good thing about this. As we near the top of the hour, let's pause now for station identification on this, the Wichita Football Network.
I'm Kendall Givens, and thank you for tuning in to the Wichita Sports Digital Network.
Give by Livingston, running play out to the 37-yard line.
Richard. I think that's Boogie Carr that was on the
carry. Oh, that is Boogie Carr. Okay. So the freshman, I love that name, out of Conway on the carry for Wichita. Is he wearing the same number as kicker Dax Jaggers tonight? Okay.
We think that's Boogie Carr.
If you'll double-check that in a minute for us, from the 37-yard line, going to pass this time. Too high, too hard, incomplete. Intended receiver on the play was Chris Hightower out of Little Rock Christian, and it's going to bring up third down now.
Third down and five.
Third down, Wichita. 5 yards needed for a first down. Tigers work from their 37-yard line, leading 42-0. Clock stopped with 8:45 left in the first half. Come out of the pistol this time. Carr set to the right of his quarterback. Going to be a quarterback keeper. Not going to be much there. And Joe Couch is going to punt for the first time this evening. Fourth down. And two from the 40-yard line. Richard, did you check that?
Well, we think it's Boogie Carr. They're not for sure either. There's been some uniform issues with the Tigers having to switch some things around. So we think we're pretty positive that was Boogie Carr in there.
Definitely not Jagger, so we think it is Boogie Carr.
Yeah, they're not letting the kicker run the football. We haven't reached that point in the football game. So on fourth down and two, Wichita will punt for the first time this evening. Snap a good one, big rush on, but the kick is an excellent one. It's going to go out of bounds on the near sideline. That is the Wichita sideline. They're going to spot it up at the 20-yard line, so it'll be first down and 10 again for the Rangers from the 20-yard line. Wichita, 42. Northwestern, Oklahoma, nothing. 7:53 remaining in the first half still at Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia. This big crowd has looked on and watched Wichita roll so far in this first half of play, and are going to see plenty of young people the rest of the way. Here come the Rangers. Going to be Ethan Everson again as the quarterback. Everson passes out in the right flats. Got a receiver. Breaks a tackle. Breaks a second tackle. Goes up over the 25 to the 26-yard line. Gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down and 4 for Northwestern Oklahoma.
JT Towers on the tackle, Rex. That's a familiar last name.
Absolutely it is. Absolutely. From the 26-yard line. Rangers. with their white jerseys, black numerals, white pants, black helmets tonight. Second and four from the 26. Let's see if they can pick up a rare first down. Gibb on the ground, coming right and not getting that first down. In fact, it's only going to be the 28-yard line and bring up third down and two.
And that's the bigger running back. We haven't seen him yet, Josh DeMonch, 215 pounds, and he was a load to bring down. Kind of surprised we haven't seen him with the carry yet. But doesn't get the first down, but this is a third and short situation here.
Haywood on the tackle, third down and two from the 28-yard line. You would think they would run it up the middle again. Everson now in there at quarterback. Gibb, over right tackle, and it is a first down. Out to the 33-yard line. That was a gain of five on third and two, first down and 10 for the Rangers from Alva, Oklahoma.
He's got a big offensive line. That time they just use the big running back, get behind the big offensive line, and get that first down.
Yep, and he's going to stay in there. They'll probably keep running the football here. They're ready to get to the dressing room, I can assure you, after this first half. Give and coming right this time, and maybe a yard. And that's going to be it this time around, Richard. It's good job by the Wichita defense with a lot of the young people already in there.
Yeah, it was a host of Tigers out there. One of the first ones trying to see may have been Mario Ganter Jr. actually out there, the defensive back, a corner. And you love seeing a corner getting in there and mixing up with a running back. And he stood him up and then had a lot of help.
That was Josh DeMatch, a junior running back out of Arlington, Texas. This time, trips to the near side. One receiver to the far side. They're passing near side and incomplete. Trying to dive and catch the football was Travis Romar, but the quarterback was rushed. And so it'll bring up second, make it third down for Northwestern.
Third and 10, and this is a definite passing situation. They've gone with a lot more quick passes lately, Rex, so they don't get those sacks. But we'll see if the Tigers dial up a blitz here. I kind of think they're probably just going to sit back in a base defense.
Third down and 10, trips to the near side. Quarterback rolling near side, in trouble. Sacked back at the 22-yard line. Another sack for Wichita. That time it was Chance Taylor coming through.
And they did set in a base defense. It was just a four-man rush, but they did a rolling pocket and didn't really do any of the blocking when they rolled the pocket. And Taylor, easy sack. That's his. He got one and a half last week, so he's two up to 2.5 sacks on the year.
So it's going to be fourth and 21 at the 22-yard line. And Connor Flanagan's going to have a chance to return a punt yet again. Very low snap. It bounces. They get it off. Flanagan takes it at the 40 and fair catches it. But again, the offense is not going to have far to go, Jeff. 60 yards away from the promised land with the first and 10.
And the second team offense we expect to come back out. We'll see after one possession if they are going to be ready to plow down the field, running and passing with Livingston at quarterback.
Wichita leading 42-0, 4:57 left in the first half tonight here at Cliff Harris Stadium. 42-0, Wichita. Tigers home again. Another 6 o'clock kickoff next Saturday against 2-0 Southern Arkansas University. Coming out of the shotgun. Pitch on the jet sweep. Looking for running room. Out over the 40, out to the 43-yard line. Goes Washington's Carter McElhaney out of Greenbrier. Saw a bit of McElhaney last week in that first game too, Richard.
Yeah, especially on the kick return. He is fast. That time broke one, not a big guy, but broke one tackle and got stood up, and the Tigers wanting to hit out of bounds, but no flags. I think the officials are trying to roll this one along pretty well.
Yep, they're trying to get to halftime also. Yep. It's a hot first half. They're ready for a drink of water after all that Wichita scoring.
Field
second and seven.
Is in the shade now.
Yep. Second down and seven. Ball from the 43. Eli Livingston actually under center. Something you don't see real often out of a Wichita offense. Give over left tackle, and it's going to be a yard, about 2 yards short of the first down.
That time running, he's got some of the backups, and he was running behind Hunter Nucci and Cooper Dar, the left tackle and left guard out there.
You know, that remind me coming under center and handed it off to that tailback. That's like the old Buddy Benson offense, isn't it, Jeff? We called all those years.
It was, and it's got him in a position where third down should be makeable.
Eli Livingston, let's see if he goes under center again. His running back is Chris Henley Jr. Not going to come out of the shotgun this time. On third down and two. Give to Henley. Henley's got running room. Watch out. Here he goes. 40, 35, 25, 20, 15, 10. Run down from behind, but not before. It's going to be first down and goal to go, Washington.
Heck of a cut about 5 yards into that run, and that's kind of what sprung it. Got run down by a defensive back that had a good angle, but nice burst getting through the hole by Henley. That's the first real big run we've seen from him. He's going to check out, and Isaac Edwards is going to come in the ball game.
First down and goal. We mentioned Henley had speed. I was impressed by him last week, Richard, and off to another good start this week.
Yeah, he's going to be a good player for the Tigers. Another good running back out of Texas.
Let's see if Isaac Edwards out of Texas can get a touchdown. Going to let the quarterback keep it this time as Livingston pulls inside the 5 to the 3 yard line. It'll be second down and goal. More extracurricular activity out there, Jeff. That's what you hear the crowd reacting to.
A little bit of frustration, but I think everybody is under control now. We'll go back to play.
I think there was a little bit of acting on both sides there, too, possibly.
Eli Livingston, the Washita junior out of Batesville, going at quarterback now. Washita trying to add to a 42-0 lead with 2:36 remaining, and we have a timeout on the field. Washita 42, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Washita football 2023, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Ferris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Washita Football Network.
Bats and signs all around Arkadelphia. When you see the Badger equipment trailer on the way to a Badger game, Bats and Signs did that. When you're watching the Badgers, Tigers, or Reddies and see the signage that just really makes their facilities pop, Bats and Signs did that too. You see the signage in downtown Arkadelphia on the campuses of Washita and Henderson, or the sign in your neighbor's yard supporting a candidate or their favorite Badger? Yep, Bats and Sign did that too. Longtime residents and supporters of all things Arkadelphia, called Mark, Jared, Chris, or Ryan at Bats and Signs today to see what they can do for you.
The Washita Tigers' second team offense is threatening to score.
They're knocking on that door again, down between the 3 and the 4 yard line, Richard, as the sun now finally going behind those trees and giving me some relief over there to the west.
Yeah, this is kind of when you wish those Henderson Hills were a little higher over there on days like today.
Woo, I'm sweaty already. Let's see what Livingston does here. Got a man in motion. He's going to keep it himself again, trying to get outside. He's pulled down from behind. Had one tackler out there, Jeff, and he avoided that. It had been a touchdown. Couldn't do it, though. Gets to the 2, and it's going to be third and goal.
Nice job by Antoine Martin to make that tackle. He is a team captain for Northwest, only a sophomore from Arlington, Texas, and he was able to just grab the quarterback by the shoulder pad, pull him down.
Third down and goal from the 2. Washita trying to add to the 42-0 lead with 2:05 and the clock running in the first half at Cliff Ferris Stadium. Running back this time for Washita, Chris Henley Jr. From the 2-yard line, Livingston is under center this time. Livingston fumbles the snap, picks it up himself, goes toward the end zone. They're going to say he didn't get there. At the 1 yard line, Richard's going to be fourth and goal.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen a quarterback fumble the snap and actually get positive yards out of it, but got down to the 1, and so Washita is just going to kick the field goal here up 42-0.
Yep, 42-0, fourth down and goal. And so Gabe Goodman comes on for what will be less than an extra point. This is an 18-yard field goal attempt. 18-yard field goal attempt, far hash mark, snap, hold, kick, and good. And Washita's lead goes to 45-0. Washita Baptist University 45, Northwestern Oklahoma State University 0. Washita football 2023, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Washita Football Network.
Captain Henderson House. We're a home to call your very own when you're away from yours. With a porch to end your night on, surrounded by friends, sharing stories and old times. And a yard with memories of summertime weddings and picnics after the game. We are so thankful for the life this house has seen for nearly 150 years. Come stay with us and join in on our stories. Captain Henderson House, Inn and Events.
Golden Goodman made it from 18 yards. Wichita 45, Northwest Oklahoma 0.
Got a special message from Dallas.
We sure did.
Cliff Harris, as we sit at Cliff Harris Stadium, couldn't make it tonight, but says, I'm watching the game from here in Dallas.
And he's right now seeing a shot of the crowd, and what
a huge crowd
it is.
Look at this crowd, Cliff. Wow. A full house on the home side tonight, and Wichita is rolling. Cliff, hope you can make it up maybe for next week's game against Southern Arkansas. Kick will go into the end zone. First down and 10, so glad to have Cliff Harris listening in to our broadcast tonight and watching the Wichita Digital Sports Network. Those students do such a fine job, Chris Babb and his crew. First down and 10, so these home games, we come to you both internet and radio, largest radio network in NCAA Division II. We thank our stations that reach all over Arkansas.
Don't look now, Rex, but they got you on camera.
Oh, no. I won't. First down, 10 yards to go. I have a face for radio, Richard. Here is the give, right side, out to the 30-yard line, out to the 34-yard line, out to the 35. That's going to be a first down, a 10-yard gain for Darian Gill. One of the better plays of the night for a team, Jeff, that had a total of 1 yard at the end of the first quarter.
Really good run by a good running back who's checked back into the game now. Wichita, of course, playing a lot of the younger guys. They're playing very well on defense. They've had that opportunity for a couple of possessions now.
Ethan Evanson now going at quarterback. Evanson will give over right tackle. Going to be a gain of 3 yards up to the 38-yard line, where it'll be second and 7.
Big tackle that time. It looked like, trying to see on that tackle, Brock Baker came in and made the tackle. That's brother of one of the receivers for the Tigers. He came flying in from a safety spot and made the tackle. Baker, a freshman from Bells, Texas.
Second down and 7 from the 38. We're down to 31 seconds left to go in this first half. Here is the give on the ground again. No gain this time. In fact, a loss of a yard back to the 37 as Darian Gill got the give again. And on 3rd and 8, I think they'll just let the clock run out. I know I would let the clock run out if I were Northwestern Oklahoma, Jeff.
Yeah, the tight end that time tried to make a block and just couldn't do it. So a couple of Tigers fell on the running back very, very quickly. And you're right, 3-2-1. We're going to see the end of the first half.
Richard, your thoughts on this first half tonight in Arkadelphia?
Well, you know, one of the best first halves I remember the Tigers playing was last year against Arkansas Tech when they scored on every possession. But this is a better first half because they forced so many more possessions and the defense looked great. I mean, I don't think you could ask for anything better in your second week.
Jeff, thoughts on the first half?
Well, Wichita looks in better than midseason form, don't they? This is just amazing execution by the offense, defense playing hard, forcing tackles for loss. And Northwestern, I don't think they know what hit them. Everybody will try to regroup for that team at halftime. Wichita will continue to tune up and let the young guys get some action.
That concludes the first half. Stay tuned now for the Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas Halftime Report. It's coming up next here on the Wichita Football Network. Presented by Visit Hot Springs.
Tiger Nation now taking the field, the 2023 Wichita Marching Band. Tonight we feature our spirit show with every Tiger fan's favorite tunes. We begin our show with the Wichita Fanfare. Thank you.
We are joined by the Wichita cheerleaders and the new dance team for Eye of the Tiger. Be unbroken. We look forward to our next performance for you again next Saturday. And as always, we thank you for your support. Now, Tiger Nation, please welcome to the field the 2023 Wichita Tiger Dance Team. The team is coached by Ashley and Melissa Carrozza. Ladies, your music is playing.
down for me.
Say, do you remember? We were dancing in September.
So excited to share with you today a sneak peek into the 45th Tiger Tunes. Talented directors from 11 clubs and organizations on campus have created shows with a certain theme. In just a moment, they will be revealing those to all of you. These groups will practice many hours on these themes over the next few weeks and produce energy-filled 6-minute shows. So let's hear what we'll be seeing at Tiger Tunes 2023.
All right, guys. Let's ponder some ideas for this next.
You know, beta fish.
No.
Beta.
No. Beta Ben Sells.
No.
Beta
Weatherman.
No, he did it last year. Yeah. What? Beta
Christmas.
Lights, camera, action. Get ready. The men and women of Campus Ministries are bringing you Behind the Scenes.
What's Cavalta's Tunes theme again?
It's nursing home.
Oh, it's campers.
No, it's nursing home.
What? Did you say chickens?
No, it's nursing home.
Oh, it's disco.
Oh, it's disco, ain't it? No, it's nursing home.
Oh.
Kyle to nursing home.
Gosh, I can't get any of my music to play. My signal in here is horrible.
Well, I would stream mine, but all I'm getting are ads. There has to be a way for us to listen to all of our music without all of these problems. Maybe we should just do it ourselves.
The Women of KyMU presents XM Radio.
Is this thing on?
Let's switch.
The Women of EEE are on tour.
It's 8 degrees, baby.
No. Get out of here. Come on.
8 degrees.
Girl, guess what?
What?
He finally proposed.
Oh my gosh, you're getting that ring by spring.
I know, right? Do you think you could be a part of my wedding party?
Of course I would. I'd be honored.
Gamify wedding party.
Dude. Do you think zombies get this?
No.
Why do you say that?
They're green.
And?
Just green things don't exist in life.
I don't think so.
No brain.
Kappa Chi Zombies.
Hey, man.
Hey. Yeah.
What's your favorite fishing lure?
Man, probably battery and chain, kitchen sink. What about you?
I think my favorite would have to be dynamite, probably.
That's a good one. Hey! What did you say? No, sir. He said the Rosig Tiger Tunes is going to be the bomb.
Ro Sigma, reel them in.
I really just love it.
I know, I love the nugget.
Can I? Yeah, just, thank you.
Do you want it? Yeah, it's okay. You can. I told you. People love a nugget. I mean, Chick-fil-A is classic.
Those were some amazing ideas, and I can't wait to see them come to life.
Tiger Tunes is September 27th through the 30th, and details can be found at obu.edu/tunes.
We can't wait to see you at Tiger Tunes.
Hello and welcome to This Week at Washita. I'm Haley Short.
And I'm Kay Ellis.
And we are your hosts every week. But speaking of big weeks, this is a huge week for Washita. This could be nicknamed the anniversary week.
That's a good name.
For Washita. Mm-hmm. So September 4th was Washita's 100th anniversary for Cone Bottoms. And all of you alumni probably have taken pictures on the steps of Cone Bottoms. It's a huge part of just Washita as a whole. And so they had a huge celebration. They had lawn games. They had purple ice cream. They had lemonade. And on Cone Bottoms lawn, they had an aerialist. She was in silks doing lots of little tricks and everything.
So cool.
It was 1920s themed, so they threw everything back, and it was kind of a time travel trip backwards. But mm-hmm. One of the things that I could have never called from Washita doing was bringing a hot air balloon onto Washita's campus.
It was so cool. So many students got to go up into
massive.
It. And the line was so long.
I mean, neither one of us made it in the line. And we're the host of the show. I mean, we should get VIP passes.
Absolutely. But, I mean, it was a huge hit.
I mean, the line was so long for it. I think they're going to bring it back. They've teased it. So this is my announcement. Watch how you should bring the hot air balloon back for the
Please
students.
Do. Fingers crossed.
No, yeah. But we also had another, an even larger anniversary this week. Tell us about that.
Yes. Well, on Wednesday, September 6th, it was 137 years of Washita. And Washita commemorated by doing this sweet Instagram post with some really old photos, and it was really cool to see what classrooms and people looked like back then. It was incredible. The communications and marketing team has done an outstanding job this semester on social media platforms. It has been so fun to watch.
And if you're an alumni, this is basically us telling you, you may be able to see yourself on Washoe social media in 137 years. So, but Instagram probably will be long gone by then.
Probably.
Hopefully something new new to kind of bring into the mix.
Yes.
But speaking of students,
yes,
at Washoe,
speaking of Tigers young and old, we had a Tiger Day on Monday the 4th where tons of prospective new students got to come. It was hosted by OSF, so there were tours and just lots of information for future Tigers, and it was really fun to see all the tour groups going around campus and learning all about this school. It was so fun to see.
They always host a lot of those throughout the year. I always get caught off guard. I'll walk outside just doing my own thing, and I feel like a zoo animal. You just turn, and there's a group of people just staring at you.
Yes,
just trying to live your life, and it always scares you. But speaking of like that many new students we have, this again was one of the largest freshman classes we've had at Washoe.
Yes,
but we actually, this is the first year in Washoe history that they've had to do a chapel overflow. So, like, JPAC is packed to the brim that they had to put everyone in overflow in Berry Chapel. We're actually both in there this semester.
Yes.
So it looks a little different. So it's just kind of more a stripped down acoustic version of worship, acoustic piano, maybe a little cajon drum, but that's basically the worship you'll have. And again, it's probably a little over 100 students in there.
Probably about 100, 150 students. And yes, the acoustic worship led by Blair Yeager. And then they live stream the speaker. So you're basically getting the same experience that those in JPAC are. But we just have so many enrolled right now that we had to have an overflow for the first time in Washoe history.
It's very interesting. If you get out early, your other friends are still in chapel. You're kind of like, I get to go to the food court first. So it's a weird adjustment, though, because chapel was always the thing for Washoe, that was the thing that everyone came together. So seeing it be separate is very interesting, but it kind of creates a more intimate environment, I feel like.
Oh, I loved it. The worship was incredible in the smaller Berry Chapel.
And Berry Chapel is a part of Washoe history as well. It just creates that environment of worship, and it brings the students closer together, I feel like, because you're sitting in a pew. You're not in a seat. You're not in like an auditorium seat. So I think it's a different vibe for chapel, but I'm very enjoying it a lot. But we also, on Friday the 8th, actually yesterday, we had the host and hostesses of Tiger Tunes. We performed at Stew Fridays at Coffee House. And so it was a good, fun little set. They always do this every year. It's kind of like a little preview for the people that are going to be singing. But I was able to perform, and all my friends came out and supported me. It was really fun. We got to sing a little bit of Harry Styles, Taylor Swift, but it was a good group. And that's always the thing that's interesting about Coffee House, is you never know who's going to perform. And if you don't know a lot about Coffee House, it's just every Friday, people call it Stew Fridays, at around like 12:15, 12 o'clock, you'll have some students that can sign up and just go in there to perform, or like just do a song or whatever they feel like doing. Typically, it's like 2 to 3 songs.
I think so.
But it allows students to showcase their talents on campus. And it's not just performing arts majors. You'll have lots of different people that will want to come and perform. And it kind of cultivates an environment of growth for the students.
It does.
I feel like.
And this one specifically got campus so excited for tunes. We are ready for it.
Yes. Well, speaking of tunes, you guys need to get back to your Tiger football game. Well, thank you for watching This Week at Washoe. I'm Haley Short.
And I'm Kay Ellis.
Bats and signs all around Arkadelphia. When you see the Badger equipment trailer on the way to a Badger game, Bats and Signs did that. When you're watching the Badgers, Tigers, or Reddies and see the signage that just really makes their facilities pop, Bats and Signs did that too. You see the signage in downtown Arkadelphia on the campuses of Washoe and Henderson, or the sign in your neighbor's yard supporting a candidate or their favorite Badger? Yep, Bats and Signs did that too. Longtime residents and supporters of all things Arkadelphia, called Mark, Jared, Chris, or Ryan at Bats and Signs today to see what they can do for you.
I've heard people say Owachita.
Owachita.
Achita.
Owachita.
Is it pronounced Owachita?
Searching for Washita Baptist University.
Back in Texas, everybody pronounces it Wichita, but really, it's Washita.
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 How would you pronounce it?
Washita.
Washita.
It's Washita Baptist University. Get it right.
It's Washita, people. It's Washita.
Washita.
And so it's really going to be interesting to see, and not really just the future of the Tigers, but some of these guys are going to make contributions later this year, because injuries are inevitable with football, so it's good to get some guys in early and just get them used to the game flow. And so it'd be fun to see some of these. A little bit of a challenge for us having to call different names and numbers than we're used to, but that's a good problem.
One of the guys we see deep to return this kick, 5'8", 165 freshman from Greenbrier, Carter McElhaney, who might be the fastest player on this team.
I think he is the fastest player on this team. I was thinking to a Washita player that I have remember that's faster than him or as fast. The only one that comes to mind is maybe Etaj Allen, and that's about it. I mean, he's very, very fast.
Let's go to the voice of the Tigers, Rex Nelson.
Thank you, Dr. Jeff Root. Yeah, McElhaney's got a whole nother gear we saw last week, and they kick away from him, brought out over the 20, out over the 25, out over the 30, out to the 35-yard line. Still a good return for Washita's – who was that? That was actually Jalen McKinney returning the football? No, Treadwell.
Larrick Treadwell.
Yeah, Larrick Treadwell was the other one. So they obviously saw the film from last week and are kicking away from McElhaney.
And his returns were called back because of holds, but I think they just saw the pure speed.
Yeah. But a good return by Treadwell. So out to the 35-yard line as Washita will come out of the pistol to start this third quarter of play. Give over right tackle, running room out over the 45, out to the 47-yard line. And that is Washita's Chris Henley Jr. We talked about Henley in the first half. He is a redshirt freshman out of Glen Heights, Texas, and he's got speed, Jeff.
Givens thinks he might be the most talented running back on the team. Now, Givens isn't going to give up any playing time. He scored a bunch of touchdowns in the first half, but they really like Henley, and he's popular with his teammates.
Eli Livingston, the quarterback. Henley set behind him in the pistol. Send a man in motion right to left. They'll give to Henley again. Henley looking for a hole, finding it inside the 50, inside the 45. Another first down, Richard, as Henley picks up 10.
He's a big running back at 6'3", 215, but you don't look at him and think big running back, Rex. He's just really well built, just a strong guy. Nice run that time, good balance, showed it. He's going to come out. Boogie Carr, the freshman out of Conway, is going to be in there now.
First down and 10, ball at the 43-yard line. Washita leading 45-0 early in the third quarter. Tigers whip the football, moving right to left from the near hash mark in this third quarter of play. They'll come out of the pistol again. Now Boogie Carr, the freshman, true freshman from Conway in there. Carr over right tackle, positive yardage there. Down to the 39-yard line, another 4 yards, second down and 6. You know, I often listen to Jay Runyon doing Conway games on the radio when I'm driving to do my scoreboard show on Friday night, and I always love that name Boogie Carr of the last few years hearing it, and now we see him here wearing the Washita colors,
a
Jeff.
A really talented young man. They think he's got quite a future also. He's got speed. He's got elusiveness. Really fine player.
Livingston on second down has a receiver in motion going right to left. Tigers moving right to left. Give to Boogie Carr again. Positive yardage as he will go to the 37-yard line. Third down and 4 for Washita. We're going to see a big dose of the running game, obviously, in this half, Richard, and keep that clock running as much as possible.
Yeah, Carr not a big back either at 5'8", 165, but just kind of wait till we can see him in the open field. You think about a swing pass out there to him, Rex, and what he can do. They've also got Connor McElhaney in the game right now. They've given it to him on a jet sweep once before.
Let's see if they go with the handoff again as they come out of the pistol. Eli Livingston looks like they're going to pass it this time. Livingston straight drop, looking left. Has a receiver at the 30-yard line. First down, Washita. Bringing in the pass for the Tigers is Jalen McKinney. He's a 6-foot freshman out of Pulaski Academy.
Yeah, they produced some good players that time. Just a good slant that time. And great pass by Livingston. He just shot that one in there on a rope. It wasn't really bad coverage, and Washita keeps picking up first downs.
First down and 10, Washita. Tigers trying to add to a 45-0 lead. Clock running, 11:37 remaining in the third quarter. Tigers moving east to west. That's right to left here in the third quarter of play. Going to run a quarterback keeper inside the 30, inside the 25-yard line. Now they're going to say out of bounds at the 25, but a quick 5 yards for Eli Livingston, Jeff, and it's second and five.
Tell you what, we saw him run some inside plays and fight for yardage earlier, late in the second quarter. This time, he got around the end and showed some real speed, picked up five where it looked like he might not get any.
Second and five, Ouachita working from the 25 of the Rangers of Northwestern Oklahoma, who've made the long trip from Alva here to Arkadelphia for this great American Conference game. Out of the pistol again with Boogie Carr set behind his quarterback. Give to Carr, big hole. He goes inside the 20 to the 19. That's another first down, Richard, and the Tigers are in the red zone.
Yeah, and he finished off that run with exclamation mark. He's not a big guy, but he got in there and delivered a hit and got the first down.
First down and 10, Ouachita from the 19. Clock running, 10:49 remaining in the third quarter. 45 to nothing, Ouachita. And they're trying to score a touchdown and say they've hung more than half a hundred on them, as the old bowl coach used to say. First and 10 from the 19, out of the pistol. Henley, the running back now, set behind his quarterback, Eli Livingston. Give, Henley looking, cuts back inside as he goes right. And they're going to mark him down at the 17. Gain of two, second and eight, but Washington very content right now to continue picking up positive yardage, Jeff, and keep this clock moving in the third quarter.
Well, Henley looks really good, up around 80 yards rushing now, doing a nice job coming off the bench.
And they will leave Henley in there as the running back. So Chris Henley, the running back, look for him to probably get it again on second and eight. Eli Livingston, the quarterback, out of Batesville. They come out of the pistol. Tigers working in the red zone now. Give, Henley. Henley can't break tackles, but still pure leg strength. Carries a couple of men with him down to the 16. And now probably a passing situation, Richard, on third and seven.
Yeah, but they executed very well in the last passing situation as they hit that quick slant for an easy first down. They're going to send some receivers in now, and we'll see what they do. But keep in mind, when they do pass, Livingston's such a good runner. If he drops back and sees a lane, Rex, he can easily scamper for a first down, or even get a touchdown. He's such a good runner out there.
Third down and seven, Ouachita working from the 16. Tigers going right to left, working from the far hash mark. Two wideouts to either side this time for Livingston. Henley set to Livingston's left. Livingston on third down, looks, rolls right, passes, and it's incomplete. That was a kind of a strange-looking play from the start, Jeff, and it'll bring up fourth down and seven.
Looked like for a moment he wanted to run, then a defender got in the way, backed up a bit, threw the ball downfield. Nobody opened, though. I think threw it away.
Yeah, I think they knew he might want to run. They did a good job closing in on him, and there was just nothing there, as you said.
So they'll send the field goal team on again. Gabe Goodman this time, a 33-yard attempt from the far hash mark. 33 yards for Gabe Goodman, the senior out of Arkadelphia. Snap, hold, kick. It is no good. Missed it wide to the right, and the Tigers finally come up empty on a possession. Will pause. It's still Ouachita 45, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Ouachita football 2023 continues in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Bats and signs all around Arkadelphia. When you see the Badger equipment trailer on the way to a Badger game, Bats and Signs did that. When you're watching the Badgers, Tigers, or Reddies and see the signage that just really makes their facilities pop, Bats and Signs did that too. You see the signage in downtown Arkadelphia, on the campuses of Ouachita and Henderson, or the sign in your neighbor's yard supporting a candidate or their favorite Badger? Yep, Bats and Signs did that too. Longtime residents and supporters of all things Arkadelphia, called Mark, Jared, Chris, or Ryan at Bats and Signs today to see what they can do for you.
First play from scrimmage of the second half from Northwestern Oklahoma. Positive yardage as the ball carrier falls forward to the 25-yard line. That is Isaiah Kellum. He is a senior out of Lansing, Michigan. Well, it's a long way from Lansing, Michigan to Alva, Oklahoma, Jeff.
It is a long way. I have to feel like they must have felt like they were lost and just stopped there.
Not sure how he made that trip. Second down and five. Back in at quarterback is Caleb Deal. So, Richard, they've come back with the freshman now.
Hey, get him some reps if he's your quarterback that you want to use all year.
Pass out into the left flats, and the tackle's made immediately at the 20-yard line.
Pierce Smalley out there.
Just Smalley, okay.
Extremely quick and great job. Great tackle, open field tackle. And some of the second-team guys in there on defense, but they don't want to let up. They want to play just as good as that first team did. And they want to keep a shutout right
now.
Yeah,
they'd love to have a shutout tonight. Third down and nine from the 21-yard line. So we'll see if Caleb Deal goes upstairs. We would think so here. He's got one running back set to his left. Trips to the near side. He's looking far side, though, and not near anybody. He was just getting rid of the football, Jeff, and they'll have to punt it away, three and out.
Yes, his receiver did not want to move toward that ball because the defender was coming right at him. So they will punt the ball away, and Wichita will once again get good field position and another chance for a punt return for Connor Flanagan.
So Connor Flanagan, we keep waiting for that big return from him.
I bet he's calling fair catch the rest of the game.
Yeah, I think
Rex.
He probably is with a score of 45-0 Wichita. Snap, a good one. Wichita. Oh, the punter dropped the football. Now he's in trouble. Back at the 15, he goes out to the 20, and he's tackled at the 22-yard line. And that is where Washita's going to have the football.
He dropped the snap, and it looked like he was going to have time to get a quick punt off. I think he just panicked a little bit.
Yes.
He is a backup wide receiver as well for them, so he's got a little bit of speed, but really just never had a chance. He was run down by Jeremiah Turner and tackled.
Boy, if it can go wrong for Northwestern, it has tonight, Jeff. I thought he had time to kick the football, too.
I think he thought he could make the end, but good pursuit by Wichita. I'm with you, though. He did have time to kick it, I believe.
So the Tigers just 22 yards away from the promised land now. Livingston gives to Henley. Henley, big hole. There he goes. Now he's pulled down basically by shoestring, Richard, at the 11-yard line.
Yeah, and he almost got out of that, but that was a touchdown-saving tackle. It was still a heck of a run by Henley, and we're seeing some good stuff from him tonight. We'd heard about how good he was, but really just a good hole that time. Did a good job picking it up, setting up the blocks. And, yeah, on the replay, they really just – hit his heel and hit his heels kind of together and was able to pull him down that way.
First down and 10, ball at the 11-yard line. Tigers out of the shotgun. Livingston, one running back set to his left. He gives to him. That's Henley again to the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised land! Touchdown, Wichita, and they've hung more than half a 100 on them.
Well, just some unbelievable cuts on that one, Rex and Dr. Root, as he just kind of stopped on a dime, was able to get upfield and got hit just short of the goal line, able to get in there and get the touchdown. Great run. We're kind of seeing a Henley grow up a little bit. Last week kind of missed a few holes. This week he's figuring it out.
On to attempt the extra point, Gabe Goodman now. As Wichita has 51 on the board. Kick is good. It is Wichita 52. Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. 6:28 left in the third quarter. Wichita football 2023. Presented by Bissett Hot Springs. Continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia. In 30 seconds here on the Wichita Football Network.
I've heard people say Owachita.
Owichita.
Achita.
Owachita.
Is it pronounced Owachita?
Searching for Wichita Baptist University.
Back in Texas, everybody pronounces it Wichita, but really, it's Wichita.
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 How would you pronounce it?
Wichita.
Wichita.
It's Wichita Baptist University. Get it right.
It's Wichita, people. It's Wichita.
Wichita.
Both of them runs by Chris Henley. Chris Henley is an up-and-coming running back you're going to hear a lot about. 5'11", 215, redshirt freshman from Glen Heights, Texas, DeSoto High School. He did a beautiful job of staying on his feet, diving to the end zone. He has shown the ability, Rex, to make yardage after contact.
I have been very, very impressed with Henley, Richard, in these first two games. 102 yards already.
Yeah, that's on just the 9 carries, too. So 11 yards a carry.
Yeah.
Of course, that pales in comparison to Kendall Givens' 4 carries for 84 yards.
That's true. But, I mean, just everybody shining tonight for the Tigers of Ouachita in this third quarter, going a lot faster now than the first two quarters did. But most of this crowd hanging in here, Jeff. It's still pretty full on this home side. They're having a good time tonight.
Temperatures dropped into the 70s. Everybody comfortable. Everybody having a good time, as you said, Rex. And I tell you, let's talk about this offensive line. The run blocking, a little bit of a problem last week. Not a problem tonight.
Not at all. We worried about the running game a little bit last week. Not this week at all. Here is the kick by Jaggers. Taken a yard deep. Return this time. Out to the 10. Again, good coverage. The tackle's made at the 9. Boy, Washtenaw has just been lights out, Richard, on coverage tonight, as that was Connor Baker.
Baker, a freshman from Pocahontas, and I didn't think he was going to get there, but he ran him down. He's a linebacker.
Great
ran down
speed.
The return man and just dove and made the tackle inside the 10.
Yeah, great speed. Now, anybody who's been to Arkadelphia knows how close the Washington-Henderson stadiums are tonight. Henderson is playing in Durant, Oklahoma, and yet the lights are on in the Carpenter Haygood press box. You think somebody came to the wrong place to cover the game tonight, Jeff?
I don't know, but they're being very nice to let them stay up in the press box.
I just wonder why the lights are on over there.
Is that a B&B maybe? Can you reserve that?
Maybe do. Maybe you can. Here is the give coming left, only a yard. And you're right, Richard. These young defenders are in there now, but they don't want to give up any points. They are playing really hard. That was Darian Gill on the carry.
Yeah, Cortavian McMillan on the tackle. He's a freshman from Hallsville, Texas, and defensive lineman ran him down for a tackle. And I mean, they're trying to keep this Rangers not just 0 points, maybe under 100 yards for the night.
Absolutely. Second down and 9 with the ball on the 9. Looking, passing deep this time. Receiver there and caught. It was a jump ball, and he came down with it at the 41-yard line. So give them credit there. There's their longest gain of the evening, Jeff.
There was a flag down as they started the play, but I think it might have been a free play. I believe Ouachita was offside.
Yeah, Ouachita reacted well to it down there. They may have could have called a little interference. There was definitely a push on the offense, but it was really just a jump ball, and they went up and caught it. It was a good play from the Rangers.
First and 10 out at the 41-yard line. Well, that'll help their offensive total a little bit
that
right there.
That might have almost doubled their yards for the night.
Exactly. First down and 10, Northwestern working from its 41-yard line, trailing Ouachita 52-0 with 5:25 left in the third quarter. Two wideouts to the near side, one to the far side this time. Give on the ground right up the middle. Out to the 45-yard line is Darian Gill for a gain of 4. It'll bring up second down and 6 for the Rangers. So how much would you pay for that bed and breakfast to stay? You've been in the Carpenter Haygood press box a lot through the years. Yeah.
Well, it's very, very nice. We love that press box. We loved for years being on top of it.
Oh,
to
we
call
did
games.
Badger games for years.
Although
on the roof there.
I'll take the Ouachita press box.
I'll stick with the Henderson House if I have to bed and breakfast in Arkadelphia.
Now, that is a nice place.
You bet it is.
Love staying at the Henderson House. Second down and 6. Ball at the 45-yard line. Lots of time for the quarterback. Rolling left. Pocket breaks down now, and he has to throw the ball away. Credit the secondary that time, Richard, as he had all the time in the world, but couldn't find anybody open.
Really late flag came in, and there maybe call interference or something there, but it was a very late flag. So
maybe a defensive holding, too,
yeah,
downfield.
It was thrown right at where the pass was thrown. The quarterback got hit pretty hard. But
a lot of young people in there for Ouachita, so they may have caught one of them holding. Now, I call it interference. Well, certainly the pass wasn't near anybody. And so it is an automatic first down for Northwestern. Ouachita leads it 52-0, 4:38 remaining now in the third quarter at Cliff Harris Stadium. Tigers back here at Cliff Harris Stadium next Saturday night against 2-0 Southern Arkansas University. First down and 10 from the Ouachita 49-yard line. Give on the ground. Going to be a loss of yardage this time for Darian Gill. Gill was coming right, Richard, and he just couldn't find anywhere to go.
Yeah, good job stretching it out that time. And it's good that Ouachita was able to get some backups in this second half, Rex, because they play SAU next week, who played Thursday night. So they got a few extra days of rest.
That
so
is a good. Great point.
It's good that the Tigers can get those starters out and get off their legs early.
Yep. You can get those starters some rest tonight because SAU got those extra days. That's a great point. Second down and 12.
And they had a heck of a comeback, down 17-3, about 3 minutes left, came back and won.
On second down, Rangers passing, broken up at the 48-yard line. Good coverage that time by the Tigers, Jeff.
Josh Montgomery, 6 feet, 170, a sophomore. Really fine job, a transfer from Sierra College. Nice job.
Out of Manassas, Virginia, right outside of Washington, D.C., when I lived in Washington. Of course, you know I'm a history nut, Dr. Root, and I love going out to the Manassas or Bull Run, as many call it, battlefield there.
Yes, yes, part of history.
Second down and or third down and 12, looking to pass. Can't find anybody open. Now gets the throw away and almost intercepted. Boy, just about coming up with the ball that time. Richard was Brock Baker, but he could not hang on.
Yeah, the ball was a little behind the receiver, but Baker was on, had it on a bead and was just went for it, diving for it, and when it hit the ground, not able to pull it in. If it was up around his waist, I think he's scoring a touchdown on that one, Rex. He just had to dive for it, and almost two picks in a row from these backups, and so they're showing out pretty well and forcing another punt here from the Rangers.
Fourth down and 12 from the 49-yard line, so Ouachita's offense will get the football back. High spiraling punt, and again, a fair catch. Now, Ouachita just gets out of the way, and it takes a Ranger bounce inside the 10 to the 8. So Ouachita, Jeff, will have its worst field position of the night.
McElhaney was deep to return that kick, did not get a chance to do it, and it rolled inside the 10. Keep in mind now, although there are a lot of young people,
10, actually.
A lot of young people on the field, that was the starting quarterback who just had the two incomplete passes. They put him back in, only a freshman, to get him more experience for the rest of the season, and the defensive backs from the second team of Ouachita really did a fine job on that possession.
Now they're going to mark it at the 12, still their worst field position of the night. First down and 10, Ouachita. Tigers lead this one by the score of 52-0. As we near the top of the hour, let's pause for station identification on this, the Ouachita Football Network.
Captain Henderson House. We're a home to call your very own when you're away from yours. With a porch to end your night on, surrounded by friends, sharing stories and old times. And a yard with memories of summertime weddings and picnics after the game. We are so thankful for the life this house has seen for nearly 150 years. Come stay with us and join in on our stories. Captain Henderson House, Inn and Events.
Three minutes, 32 seconds left. Third quarter at Cliff Harris Stadium. It's Ouachita 52, Northwest Oklahoma State University is 0. The Ouachita Tigers have the ball back, and they'll get started with a long field in front of them.
From the 12-yard line, the Tigers work out of the pistol. Livingston takes the low snap, gives to his running back coming right, and it's going to be a gain of 1 yard is all. Second and 9 from the 13.
Yeah, low snap may have thrown the timing off a little bit there, but Northwestern State did a good job kind of bottling it up in the middle there as Carr really just had nowhere to go when he got the ball.
Boogie Carr, the true freshman, the former Conway Wampuscat.
Score update at the end of 3, Southeastern on top of Henderson, 28-17.
Wow. Picked the Reddies, huh? Didn't see that coming. Of course, it could still change in that fourth quarter. Here's the pitch, the end coming around. Good running room and good positive yardage as that was that fast man we've been talking about, Jeff, Carter McElhaney. He is a freshman from Greenbrier.
He's a receiver, caught the ball on the end around and cut up the field. Good run. It was well defended because if you don't get it quickly, he's going to outrun everybody on the field. He's got great speed and a lot of fun to watch.
Out to the 24, gain of 11 on the play And it's first down and 10 for Ouachita. Tigers moving right to left, leading 52-0, 2:39 in the clock running in the third quarter at Clip Harris Stadium. Out of the shotgun this time. Carr, the running back, to the right of Livingston. Livingston rolling right, looking, passing the ball. Got a receiver who's hit immediately now at the 30-yard line after a gain of six. It's McElhaney again. Richard, second and four.
He may be rubbing some of the Rangers the wrong way because both times after the last tackle, they've gotten up and had words with him. But he's an electric talent. We kind of just want to just see him run deep and just see if they can maybe try and even out-throw him at some point.
I don't think you're really going to be passing.
Nope, I don't think you're going to lead.
Yeah, that wouldn't look very nice. Second down and four from the 30-yard line. Tigers out of the pistol again. Give to Carr, running room, but not much. Holdow closes up as he gets out to the 33. Going to bring up a third and one, Jeff, and I'd look for Carr to get it again here on third and one.
I would agree with you. Carr hasn't had a big hole to run through so far tonight, but he's had some good positive gains and some important experience early in his career.
Third and one, ball at the 33-yard line. Tigers again leading 52-0. It was 45-0 at halftime. Ouachita out of the pistol on third down and one. Livingston, long snap count, gives to Carr. Carr got a nice hole this time at a first down. So move those chains, keep that clock running. Out to the 37-yard line. And this is the kind of drive you like, Richard. Tigers have just methodically now moved it from their 12 out to the 37.
Yeah, this is kind of what you saw from the Tigers last year, more the running offense. They've been doing more passing this year, but you know they still have it. And it's just good practice to getting out there. And for one, you like to run the clock, but you want practice being able to put a game on ice, and that's kind of what they're working on here.
Yeah, especially these young people. Get them a lot of reps in the second half tonight at Clip Harris Stadium. Give to Carr. Cuts left, knocked out of bounds on the near sideline. That's the Ouachita sideline. Now that's Treadwell. He's a redshirt freshman out of Paris, Texas.
Yeah, we saw him on the kick return earlier, and Ouachita's got some really good running backs. They got five they're good with.
When Ouachita's played over in Durant, Oklahoma, Jeff Root has stayed in Paris, Texas before. You
I
love those
indeed.
Romantic nights in Paris, don't you, Dr.
It's a
Root?
Hot spot for Ouachita recruiting in more than one way. We had some good students from there.
Absolutely. End of the third quarter. It's Ouachita 52, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Ouachita football 2023 continues in 60 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
At Taylor King Law, we understand that being injured can be a stressful and overwhelming experience.
And that's why we're here to help you every step of the way.
As your dedicated legal team, we'll stand by your side when you're being ignored.
We'll be on your side to fight for the compensation you deserve.
Don't let the insurance companies intimidate you. Let us go to work for you.
Call us today and let us help you get back on the road to recovery.
On your side, by your side. When you've been injured, we're here for you.
Owned by OBU alumni, Java Primo is the official coffee house of Ouachita Tiger football. At Java Primo, amazing coffee is just the beginning. Try our great options at breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and don't forget about our amazing desserts. Also, shop Java Primo's gift selection 24/7 online at javaprimo.com.
I'm Todd Knight, head football coach of the Ouachita Tigers. When you're in Arkadelphia, come down to Main Street and support Java Primo, the biggest Ouachita Tiger fans in town.
Go Tigers!
Go Tigers!
These young offensive linemen doing a fine job. Whit Sparks, I'll mention. He's playing center right now. 6'7", 315, a sophomore for Ouachita.
Listen to these stats. Ouachita, 44 plays for 450 yards, 46 plays for Northwestern for only 59 yards. 59 yards of offense through three quarters of play is all they have. Ouachita on second down, working from the 43. Nice hole that time. Out to the 49, and it'll be a first down for the Tigers.
And just a really good hesitation that time from Treadwell. Got the ball and was headed to the hole. just kind of slowed down for just a second to let those blocks get set up and then squirted through and was able to get that first down. So the fifth running back that's played tonight, and still just a good run game from the Tigers.
First down and 10, Ouachita works from its 49-yard line. Early fourth quarter of play, leading 52 to nothing. Getting to see a lot of the younger players tonight. Treadwell again, a redshirt freshman out of Paris, Texas. Tigers moving left to right now. Still, a lot of this crowd have stayed here to enjoy it, Jeff. A little quieter now as they're watching the subs, but they've had fun this evening. Give on the counter play. Good running room this time. Down now, the hole closes up a bit. Thought he was going to have even more down to the 47-yard line. That's Treadwell. Clock keeps running.
It's going to be a face mask on that one, so okay. It's going to be tacked on. But
so it'll be a first down, Ouachita.
I mean, why would you leave? You sat through the heat wreck, so the crowd
exactly.
Now it feels amazing out here.
Now it feels great. Kick back and enjoy it. Get you a soft drink, some water. Automatic first down. And so move that forward, and another group of young players are going to try to score another Ouachita touchdown. 70 degrees, that's just about perfect
in
right
September,
there.
In September, yeah.
Riley Cornish has just checked in as the new Ouachita cornerback.
Okay.
Redshirt freshman from Warren.
From Warren? No, they produce the players, don't they?
Ouachita's had some good players through the year and still do.
Oh, yeah, year after year after year. They have produced good players.
So about Key McKnight, who had two touchdowns last week.
Riley Cornish now from Warren is your Ouachita quarterback. They come out of the pistol, give to Treadwell, and he is to the 30-yard line. Second down and 8, Ouachita from the 30.
And for a freshman, Cornish, good-sized quarterback, 6'2", 215.
Boy, you know, success begets success, Jeff. And Ouachita has had just a whole series now of really good recruiting classes.
They have had many of them. And what we see is the depth like I've never seen at every position,
yeah.
Rex, and size on that second-team offensive line.
Cornish takes it, gives to his end, coming left to right, running room inside the 30, down to the 28-yard line. That was Carter McElhaney, we've been talking about. Again, a freshman. He's out of Greenbrier, Arkansas.
And he's small, 5'8", 165, but he kind of turned upfield and was running amongst the big boys at that time and showed no fear and did a good job kind of picking a hole and getting a few extra yards. So good to see. I think they're going to work him into the offense more and more and more this year as this year goes, because that speed is something you can't teach.
Third down and 6 now. Ouachita working from the 28-yard line. Out of the pistol. Boogie Carr now the running back. Going to let Cornish throw. The ball came out of his hand, and he made a touchdown-saving tackle's what he did there, Richard. And scooping it up for Northwestern Oklahoma was Antoine Martin, a linebacker. And Martin thought he was off to the races.
Yeah, that was his first college pass. He may have been a little amped up and just squeezed that ball a little too tight, but it just shot out behind him. But good recovery to get back there and make that tackle.
Yep, quarterback made the tackle.
The defense would not have been happy with him if he gave up their shutout.
Yeah, yeah. I remember a great Bear Bryant line talking about making the tackle of a player who fumbled, and there was a big pile, and somehow the player that fumbled came up for the ball, and they asked Coach Bryant about it afterwards, and he said, well, their players were just going for a fumble recovery. Our player was going for his scholarship. Therein lies the difference. On first down, it is going to be the quarterback keeping it out to the 45-yard line. And now in at quarterback is Mason Myers. So, Jeff, a lot of looking down at the roster because both teams are clearing their benches now. This is the third quarterback we've seen tonight for Northwestern.
They are, of course, their freshman starter. Really took a beating in that first half.
He really did. So now Myers is the quarterback. He'll come out of the shotgun. He's got two men to his right, one man to his left, and a running back set to his left. They come from the near hash mark, moving right to left in this fourth quarter of play. Going to give it on the ground. going forward for very little is Darian Gill.
On the tackle for Washtenaw, John Chavy Butler, defensive end. Another, he's a junior out of Dallas, but did a really good job just seeing that play develop, shed the block, and was able to get that tackle.
On third down, here come the Rangers again out of the shotgun. Trips this time to the right side as they come from the near hash mark. Right side is the far side of the field. Rangers moving right to left, fourth quarter. Quarterback rolls right, looking on the run, in trouble, and he just gets rid of the football. And did they come up with it? I think we got an interception. We do. Washington came up with the football. He was just throwing it away, and there was a big group of players down there. And coming up with it for Washington is Jaden Hamilton Wells.
Yeah, he basically ran into a sack, and as you said, just tossed it up into a mass of people, and we had to wait to see who came up with it, and Hamilton Wells with the interception.
Boy, Jeff, that is the mark of a young quarterback. Just take the sack. Don't throw it up like that for grabs.
Yeah, he really pulled away from several people in a crowd over there. Beautiful interception, young man from Valley View High School.
Yeah, Valley View. So from midfield, here comes the Tiger offense again. Cornish gives off, looking for running room inside the 50 and getting 2 yards this time. Second down and eight. It is Boogie Carr, the freshman from Conway.
Looks like he had a bit more of a hole there, and then it closed up. He's kind of clapping his hands, kind of frustrated too, because he thought he had a little bit more.
Yeah, he did.
We want to see him in the open field.
Clock running, 10:40 left in the fourth quarter, 52-0 Washtenaw. Second and eight from the 48-yard line of Northwestern Oklahoma. Tigers come out of the pistol this time. Handoff again to Carr. He goes this time to the 45-yard line. Gain of 3, third and 5.
This is kind of a you would think Washtenaw would normally be passing in this situation. But since with the score, we'll see if they do something and keep it on the ground. But they've been so good on third down today. We'll see what they draw up here.
Eli Livingston back in there at quarterback now for Washtenaw.
If you get three or four more yards, you would normally call this four down territory, but I think they'd be punting if they don't get
it. Yep. Livingston with Carr set behind him. Now Carr goes in motion. He is to Livingston's left. Livingston, quarterback keeper, and he's got the first down. So Livingston down to the 39-yard line, Jeff, and that's a play you will see him even early in a game. They will occasionally bring him in at quarterback and go with that quarterback draw.
Really good to see, too, because get yardage after contact. That's what made the first down. He was hit before he got first down yardage, but kept going, kept his legs churning, fell for the first down.
First down and 10, Washtenaw from the 39-yard line. Livingston is the quarterback. Treadwell is the running back now for Washtenaw. Treadwell sets to the right of Livingston. They send an end in motion. Livingston again, big yardage inside the 35 to the 33. And like I said, you're going to see him come in key moments of close games, Richard, and run that play.
Yeah, and that time there was a little bit of a mix-up. Him and the running back kind of ran into each other, but he just kept it and was able to get a nice gain. And he's a quarterback, but he runs really hard, and he's a big quarterback. Listed at 195, I bet he's closer to 200 or 205, and almost kind of like a power back there.
Second down and 4, ball at the 33-yard line. Livingston pitches to his end, coming left to right, turns the corner inside the 30, inside the 20, down to the 16-yard line. And the Tigers have a first down in the red zone.
Connor McElhaney, you know, that's
McElhaney speed again.
It's basically a run, but they do call that a pass. So he gets the reception on that and a completion for Livingston. But just getting him on the corner, good things have happened. He has not been stopped for shorter than 4 or 5 on one of those yet.
They'll mark it at the 18. That was a 15-yard gain, Jeff.
Yeah, just a beautiful run. He looked like he would cut it inside, then came around the defense and just outran everybody.
Treadwell, the running back now for Washtenaw. He gets the give, cuts outside, turns the corner at the 15, at the 10, at the 5, walking the sideline and going to the land of milk and honey. Touchdown, Washita.
Really good speed to the edge there, Rex. It looked like one of the defenders had an angle on him but couldn't get there, and he's able to just kind of sneak that ball past the pylon for a touchdown. And the Tigers have a even bigger lead now as they're up 58-0.
Wow. Just wow. Treadwell showing the speed turning the corner, Jeff.
He really did. Just a beautiful job of getting to the sideline, cutting up the sideline, getting to the end zone.
Kick up by Goodman, and it is good. 7:36 left to go in the ball game. Our score now, Washita 59, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Washita football 2023, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Washita Football Network.
Bats and signs all around Arkadelphia. When you see the Badger equipment trailer on the way to a Badger game, Bats and Signs did that. When you're watching the Badgers, Tigers, or Reddies and see the signage that just really makes their facilities pop, Bats and Signs did that too. You see the signage in downtown Arkadelphia, on the campuses of Washita and Henderson, or the sign in your neighbor's yard supporting a candidate or their favorite Badger? Yep, Bats and Signs did that too. Longtime residents and supporters of all things Arkadelphia called Mark, Jared, Chris, or Ryan at Bats and Signs today to see what they can do for you.
I've heard people say, Oachita.
Oachita.
Achita.
Oachita.
Is it pronounced Oachita?
Searching for Washita Baptist University.
Back in Texas, everybody pronounces it Wichita, but really, it's Washita.
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 How would you pronounce it?
Washita.
Washita.
It's Washita Baptist University. Get it right.
It's Washita, people. It's Washita.
Washita.
With the number of snaps the second team offense and defense have had, and some players a little farther down the depth chart that have represented themselves well, everybody's playing well tonight, all up and down the roster.
Kick goes into the end zone, and so it'll be first down and 10 from the 25-yard line.
And this is a team that has played Washita tough in the past.
They have.
Last year, Washita had was able to win a little easier with them, but we think about a few years ago, it was an 8-point win. And then in 2019, it was 31-11. And then, 2021 got a little out of hand there. But this is a team that's played with them in the past, but just – and this one, it's they're not playing with them at all. Now, what you got to count in, Rex, is this is a long road trip. Washita doesn't play as good when they go all the way out to Alva. Alva, they're not going to play as good when they come all the way here, but really doesn't matter. Washita's hitting on all cylinders tonight.
Well, Washita's been in the Great American Conference since 2011, and this is going to end up, unless something strange happens in these last few minutes, here's a running play out over the 30, out to the 33, unless something really strange happens. This is going to be the biggest margin of victory, Richard, ever in a Great American Conference game for Washita.
Yeah, Washita hung 60 a few times last year. They went 63-14 over Tech.
But I'm talking about the margin of victory.
But, yeah, that's the thing. They allowed points. The Southwest Oklahoma, they put 63 up but allowed 24. So, you're right. If this holds, this will be the biggest shutout they've had or biggest margin.
Second down and 2 from the 33-yard line for Northwestern. Clock is running with 7:15 left, 59-point margin. It is 59-0 in favor of Washita. Quarterback gives to Gill, coming right side. He's short of the first down.
Yeah, really got no push at all.
1 yard, so it's going to be 3rd and 1. And, again, you know, a lot of young folks in there, Jeff, but you can tell they really want to preserve the shutout. That's important to them.
They really do, and working very hard at it. Gill, you remember, is a starter for this team. Now, they do have the backup quarterback in Everson.
Yes, they do now. Ethan Everson at quarterback, one of three they have used tonight. Give coming right. Let's see. I think he spotted him short, Richard.
Yeah, I don't think he got there. Broke the first tackle, not able to break the second one. I think getting back there and getting the tackle was Connor Bacon. Baker, a freshman from Pocahontas.
And so it's going to be 4th down, no gain. 4th and 1, and they're going to send the punting team home.
Washita sending a new returner out there. Is it Carter McElhaney going to be back there instead of Flanagan? I still think he's taking a fair catch. They actually just told him to take the fair catch.
I'm impressed, though, at how hard these young defenders are playing to deserve the shutout.
They're playing lights out. They don't want the starters getting mad at them.
No, that's a good point. They don't want to have to listen to that for the next week. Ball will be allowed to bounce. It's going to take a bit of a Washita bounce going backwards. Now it goes the other way again. It's back and forth like a pinball and finally ends up at the 34. So first down and 10 from the 34. Washita, of course, will be running the football with a 59-0 lead. And, Jeff, you think with a few first downs they can eat up most of the rest of this clock now?
I'm sure that is exactly what the plan is. Let the young blockers block for the run. Let the young running backs run with the ball and see what they can do in terms of eating up the rest of this clock.
And yeah. We should mention the new clock rules this year, Rex, that do help in games like this.
To move the chains.
Yeah, after a first down, the clock does not stop unless you're under 2 minutes. So in a game like this, that's beneficial.
Yep, absolutely it is. Just keep that clock running. Again, stay tuned for our post-game show. Richard will be going down and have interviews with the Washita coach and players. We'll have an offensive player of the game, a defensive player of the game, a big play of the game. We'll have the highlights of all the big plays. Big day in college football. Michael Westbrook will have scores from around the country for you. So you want to hear all of those. I'm afraid the bus is leaving them without the team. I'm not sure where it's driving right now, Jeff. But looks like the Northwestern bus is pulling out. Bus driver's had enough.
Wow.
First down, 10 yards to go. Tigers come out of the pistol now. Give right over left tackle. Gain up to the 37-yard line. That's a gain of 3, second down and 7 from the 37. That was Carr, the true freshman from Conway.
Rex, as we see the young guys play, I'll mention that Ricky Rogers Jr. has been in for a couple of series now, played some defense early in his career. He's a junior now and has switched to fullback. He is a wrestling champion, and they feel good about him at the fullback position. Good blocker.
See that bus turning right? He's gone. So I'll have to hitchhike home. Second down and 7. Passer across the middle, and it's picked off. At the 45, at the 50, brought back down to the Washita 44-yard line. Coming back up with it is Justin Dahl, a sophomore defensive back from Miami, Florida. But, Jeff, let's see what the flag is.
It might have been a free play. The Washita offense is not leaving the field. McElhaney was the intended receiver, underthrew him a little bit. Got to judge his speed differently.
Yeah, offsides defense. So Washita will hang on to the ball. Richard heads down to the field. We bring back in Michael Westbrook. Michael, you didn't get to see the Tigers out in Weatherford. You had other duties. So first time you've seen them this year. You've got to be impressed with everything you've seen so far.
Three drives in the first half that were each just one play. That pretty much set the tone for this one. That 35-0 lead at the end of one. It has been start to finish all Tigers.
Second and 2 after the 5-yard penalty. They come out of the pistol again. Look for Carr to get it. He does. Boogie Carr, first down and more out over the midfield. Carr down to the 49-yard line. First down and 10 from the 49-yard line. They'll move those chains. That clock will continue to run with 4:24.
I know you mentioned Boogie Carr and getting to listen to his games on the radio.
Well,
I got
you
to see him play
in person
multiple times the last couple of years.
Michael, voice of the Bryan Hornets. Of course, Conway, a rival. Yeah, you're very familiar with Mr. Carr, aren't you?
He's a fun player.
First down and 10. I can already tell he's going to have a great career at Washita. He is going to be fun. This time, pitch to the end, coming left to right, running room, 40-yard line, 35-yard line, down to about the 34-yard line, goes Washita's Carter McElhaney from Greenbrier, and you're going to be hearing that name a lot, Jeff, in the years to come.
That's exactly right, and Rex, that little pitch, completed pass, the first one in the career of Joel Allen, who's in at quarterback.
Okay. So 34-yard line, that was a gain of 15 yards for McElhaney. First down and 10, Washita leading 59-0. Tigers come out of the shotgun this time. Again, end in motion. Now they give to Carr, open field. There he goes to the house. It's Boogie Nights at Cliff Harris Stadium.
What a beautifully run play. They faked the end around to McElhaney. They handed it to Carr. The waters opened up, and it was a steady, steady run straight to the end zone. Boogie Carr got there quickly.
Now, if you were the producer that you, I thought you were, Michael, you'd have had that Boogie Nights ready to play in the background right now.
Well, it's, you know, he's a freshman still. We don't want to give him too much credit just yet, but I'm glad Richard was on the sidelines for that one. He was just mentioning how explosive Boogie Carr can be.
Oh, absolutely. Boy, he put it in another gear right there, didn't he, Jeff?
He really did, and I think that previous little shuttle pass to McElhaney really set up the defense to pursue to this near sideline. Carr went to the opposite side, had a big hole, and easily scored the touchdown.
34 yards for Boogie Carr, the true freshman from Conway. And our score now, Ouachita 66, Northwestern Oklahoma nothing. Ouachita football 2023, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
I'm Rex Horn, the interim executive director of the Arkansas Baptist State Convention, and today I'm joined by my friend Dylan, who's an attorney with the Arkansas Baptist Foundation, with an important word for you.
The foundation is here to help you support your Ouachita Tigers. If you'd like to create an estate plan that supports Ouachita and its mission, or learn about other giving opportunities, please contact us using the information below.
Four plays and a very important offsides on Northwestern. Let Ouachita keep the football. The result is a touchdown, 34-yard run by Carr. Four plays, 66 yards on the drive. Ouachita 66, Northwestern 0.
Nice job on that music, Russ McKinney. Here's the carry out over the 10, out to the 20, out to the 22-yard line. And that's where Northwestern will go to work. Ouachita's got some people signaling. They came up with the football, guys.
They are signaling
they're
that.
They're piling them still. I think they may have, Michael.
The fact that they're
they
waiting
did. For now, let's see if we can see who comes up with it. Looking through the binoculars here. So the offense is going to get to come back on. Boogie may get him another one. Ouachita comes up with the fumble recovery.
Well, the official took the ball in the pile there. So
it looks like Braylon Johnson coming up with it. I believe it was Braylon Johnson. He's a sophomore defensive back. Yep, out of Whitehall. So Braylon Johnson lets the offense come right back on, Jeff, at the 21-yard line.
As we've called out a lot of these names, we've called out their hometown, their high school as well. You can tell a couple of things. There are a lot of Arkansas high school kids on this team for Ouachita and quite a few from the Dallas area too.
And now Treadwell comes back in as the running back. And, you know, he wants to score again. So from the 21-yard line, Treadwell's going to get the give. Over right tackle, driving his feet inside the 20. Tigers are back in the red zone at the 17. Second and six. And, I mean, even with a lead like this, when you got the backups in, Michael, you can't tell them to fall down. I mean, the defense still has an obligation to stop them. And these kids want to score.
Especially not after recovering a fumble right there. If Ouachita can get in the end zone, Rex, they're going to have close to 600 yards of offense.
Unbelievable.
Only 72 yards for Northwestern.
That just, it's been a memorable night, Jeff. That's all I can say at this point.
It sure has. We're going to remember this for a long time.
Now I think they're going to go, even with 2.5 minutes still left, they're going to start kneeling it out, Jeff.
They will. It's second down, though, so we'll see how much time they can knock off. Clock is running, though.
Yep, in the victory formation now, and try to run the rest of this clock out. Well, no need to run this one up. Joel Allen, he is a 6'2", 190-pound sophomore out of San Antonio, Texas. And it brings up third down as the clock now runs under 2 minutes, 203, 202, 201, 2 minutes and counting. And I don't know that they can run it all the way out, but they don't want to add now, obviously, Jeff, to a 66-0 lead.
This is indicative of the quality head coach that Wichita has. They're really not going to be able to run out the clock here because this is third down.
Yeah.
But they are going to be able to, show some consideration to Northwestern.
Yep, Allen will kneel it down again, and they will be able to run it here under a minute. Michael.
Under a minute, and they won't even attempt a field goal, it doesn't appear.
No, I don't think so.
Moving out onto the field for that.
So we're going to have a 66-0 game tonight. I saw a Wichita win coming, but I didn't see a 66-0 win coming, Jeff. I'll put it that way.
I honestly did not either. Obviously, you're right. Wichita was coming in expecting to win. The fans expected that. We expected that, but you expected them to work on some things that were not quite up to par last week, and instead of having to work on that, that was a shining star tonight. The running offense was beautiful.
They will kneel it out, and that will stop the clock, Michael, on a change of possession.
Well, and you almost wonder what Northwestern will do. Will they kneel it twice and be done as well? I would think they would probably hand the ball off, but there's really no sense in that.
Yeah, 53 seconds is all we have left in this one. Now, next week, gentlemen, is going to be a whole different story. This is a very good Southern Arkansas team coming in, Jeff.
It really is, and they'll be high as a kite to play Wichita. Wichita's on everybody's mind as the team they want to
buy. Everybody's Super Bowl now.
That's right.
Absolutely. So let's see what they do. They will keep it on the ground for a yard. And let's see when they start that 40-second clock with 45 seconds left in this one. They'll have to hand it off one more time, Michael. That will be it.
I usually have an internal clock that puts me in a different mood later in the year for the Mule Riders.
Yeah.
I'll have to get
earlier
ready for
this
that.
Year.
To get
you
ready
have to
for
get
that
ready
a little
earlier.
Bit earlier this year.
And, Michael, let's do note, they've got 20 returning starters on that team this
wow.
year. Here is the give over right guard, and that is going to be it as we are down to 17 seconds. The number 8 team in the country will go to 2-0 on this 2023 season following a 66-0 victory over Northwestern Oklahoma. Painted purple, Wichita. The Tigers are 2-0. And we will wait for Richard to get the head coach, and I'll let Jeff try to sum this one up. I'm pretty speechless after this great performance.
Well, we hope everybody joined us for every moment of this, but if you didn't, it was touchdowns in a hurry. 2 3-play drives followed by 2 1-play drives, and Wichita led 28-0 with 3:06 left in the first quarter. And the Tigers just kept scoring.
And kept scoring and kept scoring and kept scoring. Led 45-0 at the half. Outscored Northwestern 21-0 in the second half of play. And end up winning the football game by a final score of 66-0.
I don't know if Richard will mention it, but they hold Northwestern to 18 yards rushing, 56 passing yards for a total of just 74 yards of offense tonight for Northwestern.
All Wichita tonight, and the Mule Riders of Southern Arkansas University come in next week as they will be taking on Wichita in a 6 o'clock game. Let's go down to Richard now, who is about to get Coach Todd Knight. Go ahead, Richard.
Here with Head Coach Todd Knight. And Coach Knight, your team had a long road trip last week and comes back, first home game. There's always some distractions with that. And a team that a lot of people think you may win, but seemed like y'all came out incredibly focused and maybe the best half of football we've seen from your team in a long time.
Boy, I tell you what, just everything went right. You know, it's just one of those quarters. That first quarter was pretty amazing. And, you know, play calling on both sides of the ball. Felt like we were hitting on all three phases of the game, offense, defense, special teams. And the guys, I mean, that's really what practice looked like Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. You know, so I hope it makes a point with the guys. But, hey, it's never as good as it seems, never as bad as it seems. There's a lot of things we got to improve. And, you know, we've been where those guys, you know, years ago, we've been where Northwestern is, and we get it and we understand. But very proud of our team, our coaching staff, and, you know, our support staff too. It was a great night for us.
Well, your defense holds them to under 100 yards total offense and gets a shutout. And that's also with getting a lot of second-team guys in there in the second half, and they're still running the ball. Talk about especially some young guys are getting in there.
No doubt. Being able to play those guys in the second half. Now I'm a little bit worried about conditioning with the ones, but it was great to play those guys. And I tell you what, we didn't let down a whole lot. You know, when the twos went in, I was impressed with the way they played. It was good.
And finally, I know you emphasize special teams. We saw the enthusiasm, especially the special teams on the kickoff coverage unit and several others. Talk about those guys.
Well, you know, we planned the game to defer, you know, and try to pin them, and then put our punt return team in there and try to pin them again. And it worked out like we wanted, and they set the tone. You know, you set the tone with kickoff return and with kickoff, the first play of the game. And you know, we talk about that tip of the spear and being the first one in the game. They've done a good job with it.
All right, thanks. Congrats on the win. We look forward to a fun one next week.
Thank you.
All right, Jeff, if you can keep an eye on Richard, I know it'll be a couple of minutes here. If you'll just keep an eye and let me know when he grabs some players, I'm going to start working through these Church at Rock Creek final statistics as Ouachita wins it by a final score of 66-0. Tigers had 27 first downs tonight compared to only 7 for Northwestern Oklahoma. Ouachita, 44 rushing plays for 311 yards. Northwestern Oklahoma, 35 rushing plays, only 18 yards on the ground tonight. Ouachita, what a night through the air. 17 of 19, no interceptions, 250 yards. Northwestern was 9 of 19. There were 2 Ouachita interceptions, 56 yards through the air. So Ouachita outgains Northwestern 561-74. You heard that right. Ouachita had 561 yards on 63 plays. Northwestern had 74 yards on 54 plays. 8 punts for Northwestern, averaging 37.2 yards per punt. Ouachita only punted 1 time tonight for 41 yards. 2 fumbles by Northwestern. They lost both of them. 1 fumble by Ouachita. They lost it. Very clean game. 4 penalties on Northwestern for 30 yards. 2 penalties on Ouachita for 25 yards. Time of possession, 32 minutes and 41 seconds for Ouachita, 27 minutes and 19 seconds for Northwestern. Northwestern was just 2 of 14 on third down. Ouachita was 6 of 11 on third down. 0 for 1 on fourth down for Northwestern. 0 for 1 on fourth down for Ouachita. Northwestern never reached the red zone. Ouachita was 5 of 7 in the red zone tonight. Tigers just made it look easy, going 47 yards on 3 plays, taking just 55 seconds off the clock for their first score. Kendall Gibbons, a 14-yard rush. The extra point by Goodman made it 7-0. Next possession, 32 yards in 3 plays, taking just 52 seconds off the clock. Connor Flanagan brings in a 14-yard pass from Riley Harms. Extra point by Goodman's good, and it's already 14-0 with 8:48 left in the first quarter. And then a 1-play 63-yard drive as Hightower brings in the 63-yard pass from Riley Harms. The Goodman kick's good, and it's 21-0 Ouachita with 5:18 left in the first quarter. Another one-play scoring drive, 43 yards. Kendall Gibbons, a 38-yard rush. The extra point by Goodman's good. It's 28-0 Ouachita with 3:06 left in the first quarter. And then another one-play drive. One play, 25 yards. Kendall Gibbons, a 25-yard rush. The extra point by Goodman's good. And it is 35-0. With 1:05 still left in the first quarter. Washita's next score comes with 10:49 left in the half. A 75-yard, 8-play drive, 3:59 off the clock. Hatfield bringing in a 36-yard pass from Riley Harms. Extra point is good. It's 42-0. Gabe Goodman adds an 18-yard field goal to end a 59-yard 7-play drive that took 3:48 off the clock with 1:09 left in the half to make it 45-0. And that was your halftime score. Ouachita 45, Northwestern, Oklahoma, nothing. Ouachita outscores Northwestern, Oklahoma, 21-0 in the second half. The first second half touchdown coming on a Chris Henley 11-yard rush to end a two-play 23-yard drive. Goodman's extra point was good, 52-0. Tigers then go 50 yards in six plays, taking 3:29 off the clock. Treadwell gets the touchdown on an 18-yard rush. Goodman's kick is good, and it is 59-0 in favor of Ouachita. And then the final touchdown comes from Boogie Carr, the true freshman from Conway, a 34-yard rushing touchdown with 3:25 left in the game. Gabe Goodman's kick is good. That ended a 66-yard four-play drive. 66-0. Back down to Richard.
All right, here with defensive end Mikey Gonzalez. And, Mikey, we're going to start with the defense. I mean, the offense put up a lot of points, but y'all didn't allow any points. You held them to, I think, 74 total yards for the entire game. They had 1 yard after the first quarter. Talk about the energy that y'all had coming out in this one, and I've never seen a defense hold a team to 1 yard in the first quarter.
You know, it was just preparation throughout the whole week. We had to come out with a lot of energy today. Just every single time. I mean, last week, I think we started a little bit slower. So, you know what, we had to pick it up this week. And, yeah, I think we did a very good job as a defense.
Well, it seemed like the energy was there. And a lot of that, it seemed like kind of started on that first sack from Josiah Johnson. Y'all were just able to carry that the rest of the way. And y'all are an experienced group that has played together a while. When you're out there, can you just kind of feel that momentum rolling?
Oh, the momentum, yes. Especially like when big plays start rolling and everything's going our way, the momentum and just carrying it on, it helps a lot.
Well, they're a team that came in, they rushed for more than they passed for last week. Is that something y'all keyed on all week, stopping that run?
Yes, actually, it was something that was brought up in meetings a lot. We needed to stop the run, and, you know, I don't think we were worried about the pass too much. I mean, we had, I think, 7 sacks last week, and we kept it up this week. So,
talk about some of those young guys, because they came in, and they didn't give up the shutout, and they didn't allow them to go over 100 yards, and they played basically that whole second half, and probably not just the second team, but some of those third-team guys, and just kept up that intensity.
I was like, very proud of the young guys, very proud to see what they could do. You know, they went out there, they fought hard, and just overall really proud of the second unit.
If they had allowed points, were y'all going to make them run laps or anything for that?
Yeah, probably.
All right, thanks. Congrats on the win. I'm state defense. Let me talk to Josiah Johnson. And I just talked about with Mikey, defensive effort was incredible from the beginning, but it seemed like especially that sack, that first sack you had, just kind of really started it off. So take us through that play.
Just trying to build my momentum. I mean, people say you make big plays, momentum get built. So that was my goal to make a big play, and the defense followed after that. But it was just good to just everybody like come together and we all just play together to make everybody's jobs easier so we can get to see the young guys play.
Well, I told him a few stats. After one quarter, they had 1 yard of offense. After the whole game, they had 74 yards of offense and 0 points. Is that the best defensive performance you've ever been a part of? You played on some good PA teams.
Yes, sir. I feel like that's the best performance I've ever been a part of.
All right, so you don't really play it much in the second half. What kind of benefit does that have for y'all going into a week, especially knowing the team y'all are playing has had a couple extra days?
It just allowed me to get under my feet, get my body back, and stay recovered. So it was just good to see who can help us in future references, like the younger players, and I feel like we got a chance to see that.
This is a group that's played together for a while. Y'all got a lot of guys back from last year. Does it kind of feel like y'all kind of picked up where you left off last year and you didn't really have to come into camp quite learning as much this year?
Yes, sir. I mean, we picked up where we left off last year, but we still got a lot of work to do, little details and stuff. But I feel like we getting better week by week as time progresses.
What's the strength of your defense, you think?
Our D-line, I say. Physical up front and getting plenty of sacks.
That's a humble guy. He's a safety and saying the other group's the best. So, all right, congrats on the big win.
Thank you.
Got two running backs here. I've got Kendall Givens and Chris Henley. Chris, I'll start with you. This is your second college game. You went over 100 yards in your second college game. So, and only 9 carries. Talk about tonight and how fun that was.
It feels great. It's awesome. It's a blessing. The O-line, they put in the work over the week. And I just give thanks to the O-line.
All right, Kendall, you only got 4 carries tonight. You did get 84 yards, and you had 3 touchdowns. And so take us through a couple of those touchdowns. It kind of just seemed like, especially compared to last week, just everything was just opening up for you.
Like he said, the O-line, I mean, they did a tremendous job up front. Everything was opening up. It seemed like everything worked tonight. That's credit to a good week of practice. We came out, and we knew after last week we had to get the run game going. And this week we got it going in this show tonight. So that's again, like he said, credit to O-line.
Well, I heard that y'all were going to watch film together this week to get ready to make sure he was hitting all the right holes and y'all were hitting all the right holes. It seemed like it worked. Chris, what do you learn from Kendall? He's a guy that's been around.
I just learned, like, just reading the plays, just the ID Mike, just reading the linebacker, knowing where to hit the hole. Just I learned a lot from Kendall. He a good guy.
All right, Kendall, y'all had three one-play drives for touchdowns. You ever been a part of anything like that?
Yeah, in high school, Little Rock Christian, we scored a lot of points. So within those points, it was a couple of one-play drives.
Well, Little Rock Christian did account for four touchdowns because Chris Hightower had one as well. Yeah, so yeah. How do you take momentum like this and from a game like this and carry it over to the next week?
It's confidence, and we're a team who need the confidence going into the next week. Building off of this, it'll be big for us going into practice and treating every week the same. Like I always say, we have to treat every week the same. So just as long as we have confidence and we come to practice, work hard, we play our game, and I think Wichita should do what Wichita does.
Last week it was pass heavy. This week you'll have more rushing. This seems like a more balanced offense than we've seen in a few years from the Tigers. Is that what you feel, too?
Absolutely. We got weapons on the outside, up front, in the backfield. I mean, our skill guys are really, really good. And the guys in the running back room and receiver, I mean, everybody's just on their P's and Q's all the time. They work hard. So I knew coming into the year, we were going to have some guys to get the ball to.
I'm going to ask you a defensive question. That defense in the first quarter allowed them to have 1 yard of offense. For the whole game, they allowed them to have 74 yards of offense and no points. Heck of a defensive performance from those guys.
Those guys in practice, I mean, it's hard to run the ball on them in practice. So and teams come out here and they try to do it and it can't be done. So we see it all the time in practice. We always like to say that's the best defense we play against. And sometimes we don't us offense guys don't give them guys no credit, but that's to keep them humble. But yeah, those guys are really, really good.
All right, thanks, Kendall. You'll get over 100 one day this year. And Chris, congrats on getting over.
All right, Richard Atkinson grabbing some of the Wichita players down there tonight in the wake of that 66-0 Wichita victory, and he's got a couple more. Go ahead, Richard.
All right, got Connor Flanagan and Riley Harms here, and guys, just a complete dominating effort tonight, and it really came out, and y'all were clicking on all cylinders from the beginning. At one point, y'all had 3 one-play drives back-to-back-to-back. Connor, I'll start with you, and you were the recipient of a lot of passes early on, but kind of what were y'all feeling out there as an offense today?
Well, we knew we'd be able to get on them early. The way their scheme was, we knew that we had a really good game plan going into this week. We just felt like it came down to execution. It was us versus us this week. We knew if we went out there and ran what we ran and executed right, we were going to get on early. That's exactly what we did.
Riley, do you know your stats for this game?
I do not.
How many incomplete passes do you think you threw?
I think I had 0. I think I had 0 incomplete passes.
You were 10 for 10, 188 yards, and 3 touchdowns. Has to be one of your better games.
I agree. I like to echo what Connor said. It was all about execution. Coach Derby had us really excited to go for this week. We knew if we could just come out and do our thing, we're going to be all right.
Run game wasn't working a ton last week. Part of that was they were stacking the box and really trying to stop it. This week, there was a big change and it was working. What was the difference?
Well, I think the biggest difference is just time with the offensive linemen, right? That group was the first ever game together. We had 3 new starters, and we actually had a change. We moved our center to right guard, right? So I think just another game under their belt. Give Coach Shock enough time, and he's going to get any group ready to go.
All right, Connor, you get another touchdown tonight. You want to take us through that one?
We'd been running that play a bunch this week. We knew the look that they were going to give us. We knew we were going to score on it, and we came out, had the play called. We saw it. I knew from the get-go that we were going to get a couple blocks and I was going to get in there. So.
All right, Riley, you play some of the second quarter, not the whole second quarter. Both of y'all are basically out the entire second half. How do you kind of keep encouraging those guys on the sidelines, but still yet keep some intensity that you got to keep going for the next week and in the next game?
Right, yeah, and that's what, you know, leaders are supposed to do. And this doesn't happen very often, obviously, where the twos get a whole half or, and in some cases, a half and another quarter. But it's really just keep them focused and locked in because this is kind of their audition, you know, for the next time this happens or next season going into the offseason, right? Because they don't give very many opportunities. And I don't know about you, but I feel pretty good with how they executed. We didn't have very many missed assignments, and they handled it really well.
Yeah, Connor, talk about some of the twos, especially at the receivers. We saw a lot of McElhaney. Talk about some of those other receivers that we've seen out there today, too.
Yeah, for sure. We've got a deep group of receivers. We've got talent up and down the depth chart. And like Riley said, those guys don't get a ton of opportunities, but games like this, when they go there and shine and prove what they can do, that just sets up better for the future because we know football things happen, and sometimes things have to step up. And so we feel really good about those guys. Whenever their number's going to get called, we know they're going to show up and perform.
And Riley, we've seen your number two a lot, Livingston, and he's coming in and running even when the game's close at times. Talk to us a little bit about what Eli brings to the table.
Yeah, I mean, he pound for pound, he's one of the best athletes we have on this team. He's a freak in the weight room. He works really hard, and we need to keep getting him more opportunities. He does a really good job in the run game, and you know, he's still learning in the pass game, but He's a really good athlete, and Coach Derby trusts him a lot, as he should, and he's going to keep making some plays for us.
As long as you stay 100% passing, I think we'll keep giving you a lot of opportunities too. So, thanks. Congrats on the win. And just one last question. Y'all get out the whole second half. SAU had a few extra days getting off. What does that mean to y'all just kind of be able to off your feet and just kind of relax a little bit that second half?
Yeah, I think that's a huge advantage. And like you said, SAU did have a couple extra days, and we were pretty lucky to come out with minimal injury as well. The big thing, though, is just like you hit on earlier, we got to stay mentally focused going into the weekend, and it's going to be a big one next weekend.
Yeah, we know it's always a tough one with them. So thanks, guys. Congrats on the win.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Richard, thank you so much. Richard Atkinson with his normal great job with the Ouachita Players. The Tigers are 2-0 following a 66-0 victory over Northwestern Oklahoma. Jeff Root, we have an early season showdown now set in the Great American Conference. Ouachita 2-0, Southern Arkansas 2-0. It'll kick off next Saturday, 6 o'clock. We expect another full house on this home side here at Cliff Harris Stadium, and we're not going to, but we could be here all night telling stories about the great games between Ouachita and Southern Arkansas, Tigers and Mule Riders, that you and I have called through the decades. Wild ones.
You know, it's absolutely true. We think about the great rivalry with Henderson State, the rivalry as it has developed with Harding. Those SAU games are so exciting and heartbreaking at times, thrilling at times. It's been a tremendous rivalry between these two South Arkansas schools, and SAU's good again, as expected. Yeah. So it's going to be a challenge, but the Ouachita team was so incredibly focused tonight. They put it away quickly. The offense, the defense, special teams, everything was working. And Ouachita looks to me like a team on a mission.
Absolutely. We've seen great games here in Arkadelphia. We've seen great games in Magnolia. Recent years, we've seen great games at that neutral site in El Dorado. I mean, we can think back years ago, SAU winning on the last play of a game, basically throwing a ball up. On the other hand, I vividly remember a game on this field, Jeff, where it took a 53-yard field goal just to send the game to overtime, and then Ouachita won it in three overtimes. That's the kind of games we've seen between these two schools.
And in El Dorado, we've seen a backup Ouachita quarterback come through in the end to win a game.
Yeah.
So it's just
from
been an amazing thing.
Like,
exactly.
Like
so
a movie
just,
script.
Just been an amazing process. Part of the excitement is because SAU is always so dangerous on offense, you never feel safe no matter what the score is.
O.B. Jones is a good
and
quarterback.
And that will be true again next week, won't it? He is quite a quarterback.
Yeah, let me tell you. Before we talk more about that one, though, we're going to talk about this one because it was fun. Coming up, the Southern Bank Corp Tiger Recap. We'll have the Church at Rock Creek Final Statistics. We will have the Hotel Hot Springs Plays of the Game. Michael will have the Jim Stillwell Insurance and Investments College Scoreboard on this busy, busy college football Saturday. And then we'll have a Southwest Auto Offensive Player of the Game, Defensive Player of the Game, and Play of the Game. It's all coming your way when the Southern Bank Corp Tiger Recap begins in 2 minutes here on